We play and call it work.
MiniWarGaming's Warhammer 40K Battle Report.
Hello, Wargamers, and welcome to another Warhammer 40K Battle Report. Today, Steve and I will be doing something, well, very different, but something that we have missed, and maybe some of you have missed as well. We're playing 9th edition Warhammer 40K. It's going to be 2,000 points of Orcs versus Necrons, and I'm playing a custom dynasty sent in by a fan. But we're playing Maelstrom of War from 8th edition. We're using the 9th edition core rules. I'm playing, obviously, 9th edition Necrons. Orcs don't have a choice. They have to play with their old codex for now, but we are playing with the Maelstrom of War rules because we've missed it. And maybe some of you at home have missed it too. So what we need you to do is leave some feedback after the game. And do you enjoy this? Or do you want to see more of the traditional 9th edition Eternal War missions until something new comes out for 9th edition? That's what we want to know. So let's go take a look at the list. We'll take a look at the table. We'll explain how this works in case you've forgotten, and we'll play the game. We are going to take a look at my Necron Dynasty first. And this is my Necrons. I just haven't played with them for a long time, and I wanted to bust them out. And the list that I was building incorporated all the models that I had, and not so much the new ones. So, like, I'm missing the Scorpec Destroyers and, like, the Ken Optic Doomstalkers. The studio has... I painted all that up for the studio, but not for myself as of yet. But we'll get there one day. Now, this is the Khafre Dynasty, and I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. And this was sent in by Eric. I apologize if I mispronounced your name. The idea with this one is, narratively, back when they were fighting the Old Ones, they specialized in fighting the Krork, which kind of lined up with Steve's list today, and we'll explain why the Krork evolved to fight against these guys, as they've been fighting a lot. So wait, what clan are you playing?
I'm playing Deathskulls.
So playing Deathskulls, and they've been clashing a lot with the Khafre Dynasty, and they have since evolved to fight against their tactics that they have used for millions of years, well, in the past and now more recent, to fight against the now Orcs. And that is, they irradiated their bodies, so they're Radwreath, which lowers the toughness of the enemies they're fighting in melee. And they are warrior nobles. They're a very honorable race, and they only deem close combat and hand-to-hand combat the true way to vanquish enemies. And they typically treat everyone as an honorable foe, especially the Orcs in this regard. Not so much vermin that they are, in my opinion, but an honorable enemy. And they don't really implore too much long-range firepower. If they do, it's pragmatic at best. And, you know, like a necessary evil against, like, overwhelming, like, massive enemy machinery or vehicles or, like, warlords and stuff like that. And if I didn't mention warrior nobles before, that is the circumstance of awakening, whereas the tradition is the Radwreath. Now, with this list, it is one battalion and one super heavy auxiliary. We have our warlord, which will be this overlord over here. He is going to have a resurrection orb and a war scythe, but I'm going to upgrade the war scythe to be the void scythe. I have not run it yet. It is quite good. It's 3 damage instead of 2. But its specialty is no invulnerable saves allowed against it. So he's armor AP4, no invul, and saves 3 damage a swing. So he can be quite devastating if he gets through. And with warrior nobles, I didn't explain what it does, but all noble characters, which are lords and overlords, I think only actually, they get to, and name characters that fill those roles too, they get to reroll hit rolls and wound rolls of 1. Which is something that they are lacking. And then behind him, we have 2 supporting characters, 2 lords, 2 warrior nobles with war scythes, and, well, that's just it. They're the old school Necron lords. A lot of the stuff I have is from back when I started first collecting them, and you'll see a couple more examples of that in a moment here. And of course, the warlord trait on the overlord, because the overlord has to be the warlord, is going to be honorable combatant. So if he is ever near a character, he must attack the character, because everything else steps out of the way, obviously, and I believe I get a couple extra attacks against that character as well. Now, on to the meat of the battalion. We do have 3 units of Necron Warriors with Flayers, because that's all I currently have. I don't have any Ghost Reapers, which is fine. Flayers are just as... I mean, they're not as good. We all know that. But they have the potential long-range fire support if I need that. And they're narratively supposed to act as kind of a necessary evil. They are shock troops. They just go in front of the noble Lich Guard or anything else they deem important to the army. They just take all the hits. They're not cared about. They're shock. They're honestly cannon fodder. They are used very recklessly and not cared for. There is an abundance of them. Though I might try to utilize them a little tactically for objectives. if that comes up, we know I did base my objective deck mostly around killing and close combat, though there are some secure objectives in there because you do have to have 18 cards in your deck. We're playing with the most recent release of Maelstrom of War, not the older iterations of it, just because this is the one people might be the most familiar with, even though it wasn't around for that long. And then the rest of my list, I have a monolith. This is the old monolith. It's going to have the flux arcs on it, which has the gun I like, though in this case, I'd much rather have the death rays. Whatever, it is what it is. It's going to beat up stuff in close combat. That's all I care about. And we have six canoptic wraiths. They are going to have their the vicious claws on them. Actually, I just recently painted these ones up, so another reason why I wanted to kind of play my Necrons. We have some scarabs with the old green flock. We have eight of them because of points. We couldn't quite afford the ninth one. We're actually off by 5 points to afford the ninth one. So now we come over to this canoptic spider, which is the old tomb spider. I still imagine the Dawn of War sounds from Dark Crusade as this thing would just ominously hover around the battlefield. It's like computer. It's like, honestly, I don't know. I picture like higher pitched keyboard clicks and
you kind of like.
No, I can't. I'm sorry. I can imagine.
Would you just?
I can give you.
I've never heard it. So
a statement of my imagination, only. He is not going to have that Gauss cannon on him, which I can't remember if it was a Gauss cannon or not, but he does have the two particle beamers, and which is what that's going to act as. And because I had 10 points left over and I couldn't quite see where else to put that into my list, honestly, he's going to have a gloom prism, so he can deny psychic powers as if he was a psyker. I don't think that's going to matter in this case. And he's got a fabricator claw, which he actually does have there. And that will allow him to repair D3 damage to a vehicle at the end of the movement phase. Well, I mean, I'll try and make that work, but it probably won't, let's be honest. It's just, it's points that I had to spend on whatever, why not, right? Stuff like that. Now, let's go take a look at the orc list and see how they have decided to evolve fighting the irradiated Kufrid Dynasty. And I do want to mention something over here for strategic reserves. These 10 Lich Guard are going to be in strategic reserves, so I'm going to be spending the command points on that. And because I'm spending command points, I'm bringing a super heavy. I am down 5 command points.
All right, here's my 2,000 points of orcs. Going to be a Death Skulls. It's a battalion, and I'm sorry that it's only vehicles, or almost exclusive vehicles, because your irradiation doesn't really work on them.
Right, so they decided to jump in 10 cans instead.
Yeah, we're adding a narrative. I did not counter Luka's list.
He was going to run this no matter what.
Yeah, I was building this for a couple of days. Actually, it's because I bought the new War Boss on bike, and I painted him up last night, so I want them on the table. So what I'm going to do is I have to ask two questions to the orc audience. Well, I'll get my list first. So the battalion here will be led by that War Boss on bike. Now, there are two ways of giving this guy a Forbindvalm. One is to play Bad Moons. We're not going to do that, because sure. Bad Moons have a Warlord trait, Forbindvalm. The other way is to upgrade him for one command point to give him like plus one attack, wounds, and a Forbindvalm. The biggest boss. Problem is, you can't do that when Gaz is on the table, so he will not have an invuln. He has a Forb save, and that's it.
Okay, so typically he would, though.
Yeah.
But why are you running Gaz? Do you just want to run another big guy?
My idea here is that I when I named this list, it's called this Big Orc. So there's one a bunch of big,
literal big models things.
To charge in.
Okay.
So the War Boss will have the brutal but cunning Warlord trait, basically making my Dekilla Claw damage 4 on the charge. He's rerolling to hit and to wound on a 4 damage attack.
Oh, I don't see his killer claw. I see a saw.
It is a saw, but no, it's upgraded to Dekilla's saw.
There we go. Okay.
And we're going to be Gaz. It's got Gaz, just Gaz. And then we're going to have the Death Killer War Trike. We're going to spend a command point to give him the super cyborg body, extra relic. And then we're going to move on to troop choices, which are going to be 3 squads of 10 Gretchen. Now, seeing as that what happened to the scouts, I can fully see these guys becoming non-compulsory troops. Or not troops in the next book, but hopefully they stay. And then we're going to bring some fast attacks. We're going to bring Megatrack Scrap Jets. We only have one. That's the corkscrew one, the second one over.
Oh, geez, the good one.
The good one. Now, I would love to have more of these, only have one. It is upgraded to have the corkscrew, so it's going to fight pretty good. And then we're going to bring a pair of Shock Jump Dragsters. They are going to be upgraded with a custom job, which what's it called? It's called the Gyroscopic Whirly Jig. And then we're going to bring one Ruckachuck Squig Buggy because it's painted yellow.
Right. Now, this one is not great.
It's one of my favorite looking ones, but it doesn't do anything I want it to do.
Right.
But whatever, he's part of the list. And then we're going to bring some heavy support choices. We have Mordekaiser because he's going to be here forever. He'll be upgraded with the custom force field and the shiny gubbin, so he hits on fours. We're going to bring a Bonebreaker. It's going to be upgraded with the red Rolla. so he has more attacks. And then we're gonna bring a Gorkonaut, and he'll be upgraded with Slug Gubbins, so his gun has more attacks, it's better to hit at close range.
Like his big gun there?
Yeah. So we spent 6 command points before the game has even started, just upgrading things.
Are you putting anything in? We are going to be using strategic reserves. Also, I know it's not part of the Maelstrom of War typically, but we are going to be using
part of the game. So, right, no, yeah. I have no interest in that. Now, here's my 2 questions. Ooh. One is for everybody, and one is for the Orc community. So, for everybody, did this model here just make this guy redundant and no longer useful?
Probably.
He's better in every way. What am I missing? Secondly, this is a question just for the Orc community. So, I'm going to say 3 things. Orc, War Boss on Bike, Mech with Custom Force Field, and the Mech Shop. How'd you guys do that?
How do you, yeah.
No, further context.
They always.
So I want them to, I love the Orc community, but how did they do that?
They just moan and complain until
they
get what they want.
No, they don't though.
They do though.
You think so?
No,
just one guy does. The Orc community I think is fantastic. They don't complain, yet somehow just just decide that we're gonna bring back, okay, I'll explain. So they took away this guy, made him Legends, they don't sell him no more.
And then everyone complained, I can't believe you took away the War Boss on Bike. It's literally our best best HQ.
Now he's back and way better.
Yeah.
Same as the Orc, the Big Mech with custom force field.
Yeah.
They don't sell no more. I have one. It became Legends. But now they added it back in the books, it's not Legends.
So I can't believe you took this model away from us Games Workshop, and now he's back in Saga of the Beast.
And then the Orc Mech Shop allows you to bring a custom job, and if you have one, you can bring a custom job, and then you use stratagems to buy more. They're like, nah, we're not gonna buy that.
Right. So like for that, it was so clearly obvious you needed the Mech Shop.
They're like, no. We decided, no, we're just gonna use a stratagem without the Mech Shop.
Right, and then everyone was okay with that.
The Mech Shop was really bad.
Right.
And everybody was like, okay.
Yeah.
And now that's...
It just seems like, yeah, from my perspective, it's like, okay, yeah. You upgrade one thing for free with the mech shop, and then if you have a mech shop, you get more upgrades.
You need a mech shop to upgrade
it's
everything.
Obvious. And then everyone's like, well, we refuse to do that. We're just not going to use the mech shop, or we're still going to upgrade things. And everyone's like, yeah, sure, that sounds good.
I don't know. How did the Orc community do those 3 things? That is fascinating to me. So I would love to know.
And the reason, I didn't really mention it before, why they've evolved the fight against the irradiated Necrons, the Kaffir Dynasty over here, is because the Rad Reed only works against infantry, essentially. Like, non-vehicles.
So it'll work against my Gretchen, and this guy, and this guy.
And Gaz. You know what? It's good enough for me. It's something.
Sorry.
So today, Steve and I are trying out old Maelstrom of War from 8th edition. Now, it's not actually that old. This came out at the tail end of 8th edition. But with this, we have a deck of 36 cards that we have rifled through and cut down to 18 that fit the opponent's army. And we are going to be trying to achieve these throughout the course of the game. Now, we are going to start the game off by drawing a hand of 5. And at the beginning of every one of our turns, we are going to take 3 cards from our 5 to fill out 3 active tactical objectives. Now, if there is already previous tactical objectives active from the previous turn, then we're only going to put down up to 3. And after we put down our tactical objectives, we will draw again from our deck up to a hand of 5 cards. And every player turn, we are going to be trying to accomplish those objectives. Each objective we accomplish will give us a varying amount of victory points based on what they are or what they say. In this style of mission, we roll off. There is an attacker and a defender. The winner of the roll off determines what they want to be. The defender randomly determines the layout of the mission after both players have already set up the 6 objectives. So they set them up not knowing what the actual deployment zones are going to be. The defender then picks their deployment zone, and then the attacker is forced to deploy their entire army first. The defender then gets to counter deploy, and the attacker will decide who goes first. If the attacker decides to go first, the defender has a chance to seize the initiative by rolling a d6 and rolling a 6. Now, in addition to the base rules for Maelstrom of War, each one of the 6 missions has an added caveat. In this one, it is Ambitious Surge. At the start of each player's movement phase, their opponent is going to choose one of their active tactical objectives, and if that player can achieve the one that's picked, they will get 1 additional victory point. It kind of entices their opponent to try and do something a little more reckless, maybe, to try and get that extra victory point. In addition to that, there are secondaries, Slay the Warlord, First Strike, and Linebreaker.
Don't forget, once you finish watching this battle report, to go check out the battle report between Josh and Matthew, Tyranids versus Adeptus Custodes. Lots of Forge World on both sides. Make sure you check out the link for the free 7-day trial.
All right, so Steve and I have finished deploying. We did the roll-off, attacker-defender. Steve won the roll-off. He chose to be the attacker because he wanted to determine well, most likely wanted to determine who gets to go first.
All our Jews.
I got Defender, I rolled off, we ended up getting Hammer and Anvil style deployment, which is this way, and then over here. Steve had to deploy his entire army first. I was able to counter deploy, in a way, and try and be a little safe if I can. And that's pretty much it. I'll show you my deployment. I went with Wraiths, Necron Warriors, because I want them to be able to go to that objective if possible, and I want the Wraiths to jump out in that direction. But I don't want to deploy... I'm not at the line. I'm actually behind the line a little bit, because Steve's entire army can advance and charge, and they move fast already. So if he rolls high enough on the advances, I don't feel like getting turned on charged. We have Lich Guard with the Overlord and one Necron Lord over there. I have a plan for them. I think I know what I want to do with them. We have another Lord over here with the Monolith behind some dense terrain, and the Spider, as well as some Scarabs and more Warriors over here. And lastly, I have a flanking unit of Warriors creeping up behind this building. And yes, we are playing on the full 6-foot by 4-foot table, which is, I don't know, it's just nice to go back to it. We played a bunch on the minimum size tables. We want to go back to the bigger ones for now. Now, what do we have for your deployment?
So I had Gretchen on the flanks and the Shock Drop Teleporters in the back. And then I got a line, just putting everything on the line, getting ready to go on forward. I'm just gonna advance and charge. You get he's gonna move forward and hope for the best.
Right.
And then the other 10 Gretchen are inside the Bonebreaker. I know it'd be nice to have a couple things in the Teleportarium. However, with all the upgrades we did, we gotta use a lot of ramming speed stratagem, so no command points to spend on deep striking.
Right, and there's ramming speed too, I forgot to mention too, where you roll 3 dice when you charge. And
then 2 plus to do mortal wounds.
Exactly. Yeah. So I gotta try my best to avoid stuff like that, at least going forward. Now, we are gonna go ahead and roll the CZ initiative here. If I don't even really care about it, but we'll see. I get to roll it myself, I'm the defender.
If you roll a 6, are you gonna choose to go first?
No.
So don't bother.
Maybe. I don't know, I'll roll and see what's up.
Okay.
Bam, so I kind of want a 4, I didn't get it anyway. So it's up to Steve, who's going first? You're the attacker.
Okay, look it. Okay, the big gun is 36?
I believe so, I haven't looked at
24.
It.
He's 24? So you move, do you fly?
Yeah, he flies.
Okay. And how far do you move?
6 or 8. I haven't looked at him in a while, so I'm not giving you good information here. I apologize.
No. That actually is enough for me to figure out what you
okay.
do. Okay. Okay, so...
It's at least 6, I'll tell you that.
Okay, you can get some... That's the only... If I let you go first, that's the only thing you can fire with, which isn't terrible for me. Are you really going to pass your turn if I make you go first?
No, I'll do a little bit of movement.
I'll probably
pass my turn for the
I know, because he wants me defensive... I'll just go.
Okay, I was gonna say, the nice thing about Maelstrom of War is you don't have to be crazy aggressive and go for the objectives every turn. That's also a bad thing too, because then you could build a defensive list like I kind of have, where I can just wait in my deployment zone until Steve does something reckless, then like, well, I don't care about the objectives, all my cards are kill stuff, so then I'll pounce on his stuff and kill things.
27.
But Maelstrom of War isn't a competitive format, it's more of a pickup.
7-inch charge on the Monolith with my Warlord. That's guaranteed to give up, say, the Warlord.
Ooh, a guarantee. Oh, me, you, yes, absolutely. And yeah. Kingslayer, if I took Kingslayer.
Now, the thing about this guy here is he'll have 6 attacks, hitting on 2s, re-rolling, wounding on...
I'm T8.
Wounding on 3s, re-rolling.
Right.
Minus 3. So you have a 6 up save?
2 up. 2 up save base.
A 5 up save. So if the all went through, because it's 4 damage on the charge,
right,
I'd kill you. But you have to roll single 5.
It's not likely. And you have to make, albeit you have rerolls everywhere, it's still not likely it'll make
every
single one.
You know what? Colin just walked in the room and is pointing out the fact that I was wrong about something.
Yes, and that Steve is not a big fan of.
I know.
Sometimes Steve is wrong, though.
Yeah, sometimes I'm wrong.
And I can't remember if you decided to
go. I'll go.
Turn 1 orcs?
Yeah.
Turn 1 orcs. All right, we'll get our decks of cards ready, our hands ready, and all that good stuff. We're going to show off cards before the command phase, because I typically do that anyways. And these are the cards Steve's going to go for. Secure Objective 2, Secure Objective 5, and Supremacy, which is hold 3 objectives. Now, what we did towards the end of the edition is these are always worth a very variable amount of victory points. I never liked that, and a lot of people here hated that too, so we just played. And I got good support from people online saying, yeah, we do that too. D3, scrap that. It's just worth 2. It's always worth the average, never a random amount, because that's just a feel bad. And it's led to some weird outcomes, albeit it can be fun and silly, but it sometimes just feel bad. Because, you know, what if I, like, Steve rolls a 1 and I get Supremacy and I get 3, then, you know, I didn't work any harder to do it. It's just not great. Anyways, to the game. Command phase. Now, I guess I should say one of these could be face down, but Steve is going to get them all anyways. I'm just going to go ahead and say, make sure I'm supposed to declare this in the movement phase, but the command phase didn't exist. I'm just going to say we're going to declare it in the command phase when I show off the cards anyways, because it's just easier that way, because it doesn't really matter. I'm just going to say this is the ambitious surge. Steve has to get this one in. Well, he doesn't have to, but if he does get this one, it's worth an extra victory point, which it should be easy. I know the orcs don't have too much to do in the command phase. You do go up to 7 command points, though.
Yes. Yeah, we're just going to move forward.
Oh, and you know what? To show off the objectives, he has to get number 2, which is there.
Number 5's over here.
5's behind that building, and then any 3.
6, 3, 1, and then one more over four. There. So I'm gonna have 3 for sure.
He just needs to stand on 3 objectives at the end of his turn. And then it's this normal rules for controlling objectives. We are playing 9th edition, so we're going to be doing from the edge of the objective, not the center.
You know what? I'm going to be going for 4 objectives. I think I'm going to go for the monolith, the church.
Sure, go for it. So are you doing anything fancy, or are you just going to advance and everything up?
I want to kill the monolith turn 1, but to do so, I have to give up my warlord. Is it right now? I'm trying to weigh in my mind. Is it worth killing the monolith turn 1 and giving up my warlord? Am I going to get more value out of my warlord in future turns than you will in your monolith in future turns?
Right.
I think.
What if you horribly fail at killing it?
Well, I think with Mordekaiser and that guy. And if I don't,
then
wasn't meant to be.
I get it. So what Steve is concerned about is once one of our it's a secondary objective we both have called Slay the Warlord, we automatically gain a victory point at the end of the game if the opponent's warlord is dead at the end of it. Kind of representing taking apart your enemy's forces.
Well, also, you did mention, I shouldn't know this, but you did tell the camera I was in the room, that you built your deck for close combat.
Right.
So I'm also likely giving up some sort of close combat objective for Luka.
Right.
So probably giving away 2 points doing this. But taking that monolith off the table is all is his big firepower and forcing his Lich Guard to come off on a table edge.
It's true. Yep.
If it fails.
If it fails, it fails. Now you're advancing him to get there. He automatically goes 20, I believe.
Yeah, that's 6. Yeah, yeah. I'm at 6.
Now the other thing, there's a card called Kingslayer that whenever you draw it, you automatically score. If you put it in play, you automatically score for 2
Did
victory points.
Did you put Kingslayer? I'm locked in.
I'm just saying, if it's in the deck, right?
I'm locked in.
Right.
Did you put Kingslayer in your deck?
I did, of course.
Did you really?
I always put Kingslayer in. No, not always, I guess. Against orcs, I always would.
I'm giving away
3.
4 points likely?
It's 1 for Kingslayer at the end, and sorry, 1 for Slay the Warlord, and then Kingslayer's worth 2 victory points.
And then, but you probably have some other killing when you might be high right now.
Sure, yeah. Maybe. It's just it's the risk versus reward. If he does take up with the monolith, it's an insane amount of points, and he's right, my Lich Guard can use the monolith to come out of strategic reserves or come on a table edge. Now, obviously in this case, if he kills that, I have to show up from a table edge instead.
So this Shock Jump Dragsta is going to advance.
Yep.
Because what it wants to do...
Does it have to advance to teleport?
Yes.
Okay.
What it wants to do is eat up that Overwatch.
Right, okay. Not that I would. I don't think I would. Maybe I would. I don't know.
So, well, it's like if you kill him on Overwatch, you 100% Overwatch. Why wouldn't you? That makes complete sense. No Invuln?
Well, I guess he doesn't have Invuln,
you
does he?
You 100% would Overwatch.
I don't know. I don't like. I always hate Overwatch. Anyways, so what does he get for advancing?
Okay, so when he advances, he could take a mortal wound. Okay, so when he advances, if it's 4+, he teleports off the table, comes back on the table, anywhere on the table, 9 inches away from enemy models, and he could take mortal wounds if you roll number. Now, with the upgrade I spent on this little squad here, they both get it, is the always advance. It doesn't matter what
I have to do. There's no roll. There's no roll.
They always teleport. I still have to advance when I do it.
Right.
And I can't take mortal wounds.
Okay, so they always succeed on the teleport. Yeah. Okay, so it's nice to guarantee to have. And they get better to hit when they teleport.
No. So this weapon here, for some reason, it used to have a rule at +3 to hit.
Right.
But because 9th edition, they errated it, let's go 3+ when it shoots.
Right.
It's an assault weapon, and I have to advance to do this, so it'll be hitting on 4 because of the -1.
Sure. That's still pretty good.
It's still pretty good.
Yeah.
I don't want Luka charging me. Even a box. You know what? I think it's boxed. Nah, we're there. We're going with that.
Happy there?
Yeah. And we're going to bring this guy around. He's going to be here, but I'm going to turn him this way so he faces the front because Luka likes my models face the front.
I do. I appreciate that. For the trees, folks, we are just playing them as obstacles that are dense. You can't move, nothing can go through them. They're just, they occupy that space there.
Jazz going advance. Ooh.
He's pretty fast. What does he move normally?
7.
Okay. So he's going 13 inches right up to the wall.
Let's do it.
Bam.
Let's put him there. We're going to move these things up into range of things. Ooh, that's a bad deck. Can't fit through. He's going this way.
All right.
We're going to send this boy up. These Gretchen are going to go ahead and just take this objective.
Right. It's part of the mission.
Okay, those wraiths kind of scare me.
Well, one thing I want to point out for the old Maelstrom of War missions, depending on how Steve built his deck, say he only had one secure objective forward, now he knows he does not need to be here anymore.
Right.
For whatever reason. He could just vamoose.
I know which one my deck, yeah.
Right.
This guy's an advance. I can't remember if he auto-advances six or not. I'm going to roll it. I don't think I'll need more than that anyway.
Yeah. Oh, he's going that direction.
Yep. Yeah. This guy's going to teleport as well.
Advancing. Boom. And again, with the upgrade, doesn't need to roll the four up.
Just, it helps me get more shots on the target. I want to make sure that Monolith dies. If that Monolith doesn't die, my whole plan falls down the drain. I'm in a bad spot.
Okay. sounds about right, I guess. It's a gamble, but it could work. If it works, it's a pretty big deal for you.
Start off with this Shock Jump JJ. He's kind of hard to see. He's building.
He's hard to see over there. Yeah.
He's going to fire at this Monolith right here. We're going to start off with his custom shock rifle. Let's skill three, but we advance, so four's the hit. I am going to use my, extra attack for that six.
Daka, daka, daka.
Let's do that first. And then I'm going to use my, Death Skull's reroll to hit. Three hits.
Now, the one thing I want to say is this is dense terrain, negative one hit, but he already advanced, so he's already suffering the negative one.
Oh, I'm also over here. Like, you're huge. And these are strength eight, so we're winning on fours. We're going to use a Death Skull's reroll because Death Skulls are amazing. Okay, we have two. It's minus three.
Okay. All right, so I have 2 5-up saves because I have a 2-up save. I will make, yikes. Well, that's five together, that's fine. It is what it is. The rifles do D6 damage each.
10.
Well, it is what it is. I'm down to 14. That's looking grim for me already. The second one?
No, he's got a missile launcher as well.
Oh yeah, missile.
Misses.
Yep.
All right, second one's gonna do the same thing. So hitting on fours because it advanced. Extra shot for that six. Doesn't help. Oh, I'm gonna use my Death Skull's reroll.
Yep.
Didn't help. Force to wound. I'm gonna use a Death Skull's reroll.
I can't see.
And I got it. It's gonna be minus three.
And oh, I failed that one too.
Yikes. D6.
He's down. Yeah, it is what it is. Eight wounds left. Obviously, I'll just make it against everything else.
Missile launcher.
Misses.
Oh god. Oh, I need a six to hit.
It's only the gun that hits on threes?
Only that gun hits on threes.
Specific
yeah.
gun, gotcha. Oof. Well, I kind of expected something like this anyways, folks. It's Steve's Orkz. It's
wow, right?
He could they're on autopilot, he could just do whatever he wants. They hit on sixes across the board and they'd still table me with
you. You know what's actually a little bit on the frustrating side? I don't need him there anymore.
Right, yeah. Unless you know everything else whiffs, everything could whiff still. Yeah. It's not likely.
This guy's gonna go down. Mordecai's going next. Okay. We hit on fours because of the guns. We're probably putting a bunch of shots on this guy, so minus one to hit.
Right.
I am, even though I think it's not necessarily worth it, I am going to go ahead and do more DACA.
Is that two command points?
Two command points.
Gotcha. That will put Steve down to five. Is the big shooter going into him as well?
The big shooters will go after them.
Sure. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
Let's do rockets. Hitting on fours, minus one.
Right.
Death Skull's reroll on this?
Could.
Sure. No. Okay. The big gun is 3d6 shots. 3d3 shots. Five shots.
All right. And fives to hit. But fives count as extra?
I think a mortal wound.
Right. That's one mortal wound for anyone's.
Extra shots for fives and sixes.
That's right.
Four hits.
Of course.
strength eight, so fours to wound. We're going to use a reroll on
the
this.
Wound here. Yep. So we have.
And
two.
We got two. Hold on. I have four left?
Yes. Five. You have five left.
Nah.
Okay, so two
just
wounds.
Just two.
And
minus three.
Three. Yikes. Five ups. Come on, dice. Is it d6 per?
Yeah.
I'll command point one. Okay, I made it. So I'm down a command point, but it's only one d6 damage and a four?
You have eight?
I have four wounds left if you don't reroll that. No.
Not rerolling it.
Okay.
Belly gun. Gets me another shot. One hit. It wounds on fours.
Quarter wound.
Oh, it's a wound.
Yikes.
Minus three.
Same profile. Oh, I made it. Nice.
So now we have the big shooters.
Big shooters over at me, warriors over there. So I at least survived that. A little more things we have to shoot at them.
Fours to hit. And then fives are an extra attack.
Yeah, there's no trees in the way of this one.
And these are strength five. So three. Threes to wound.
And no AP.
I already used a reroll, so six. But I need to clarify for everybody, to go with Death Skulls. They get to reroll a hit, a wound, and a damage
right.
for every time somebody needs it, per unit.
It's specifically good for the big, scary vehicles with
it's
big
so
weapons.
It's so good for the vehicles.
Not so much for like regular orcs. Unless they have rockets, that's not bad. Four up saves. I think some are technically in cover. These three would be behind an obstacle, which these are gonna be. So I have three of them in cover. I'll take from those ones first. Three ups. One of them dies from the back. And then we got a couple more to, well, do two at a time now. And the last one, yeah. So one guy dies, and that should be it for the Morkanaut shooting. So a reanimation on a five up. Nope, he is dead for good. All right, we survived Morkanaut. What's next?
Okay, so we're gonna go Gorkanaut next.
Oh, hey, what's
he's
up?
He's putting everything into them. It's one thing you see in the right side.
Oh, that's great, sure. Oh, he's got, looks like rockets, big shooter, and
two rockets, two twin big shooters, a flamer, which is fine, and the big upgraded gun.
Okay, what are we firing first?
I'll do the rockets first. Fives to hit. I'm gonna use a Duskull's reroll on these.
Yep.
That's nope.
A four, that's a miss.
Big shooters are gonna be on fives. Extra attack for the six. Nope. And then threes to wound.
This was into them?
Yep.
It's still only strength five?
Yeah, it's only strength five.
Should be
four. Oh, sorry, I'm doing this.
Oh, the rocket?
Oh, sorry, that.
Oh, the big
this, guy. This.
Oh, there's those two? Okay.
Yeah.
So AP has nothing on that, so two up save, we're okay. Because we have the storm shield. Well, technically dispersion shield, but the storm shield's the biggest gun.
Okay, so this gun here has 36 inch range. It has six more shots because it's upgraded. But the basic thing is when you're within 12, it's plus one to hit.
Okay, so there's fives to hit still.
Fives to hit.
Is it damage two?
Nope, just damage one.
Okay.
It's not great against you, but nothing else you can really do right now. Rerolling for extra attacks, those sixes.
Threes to wound.
Threes, but I haven't used a reroll yet because I won't save them for this one.
Yeah, the death skull reroll. Ooh, that was that? A wound. Yeah.
Okay.
So we have
six up minus one.
Okay. The two up save will go to a three up. And I am going to. Do I care about losing one here? Do I? Yeah, whatever. It's. Ah, man. What else is shooting, though?
I have these two.
Right.
And I have.
How much damage do those two do?
He's got rockets and big shooters. He can do. He has so many different shot profiles.
I think
he picks.
There might be value. Losing him, there might be value in keeping them around as long as I can. So we're going to command point one of those. Okay, we just take one wound on that guy back there. What am I talking about? I already used a reroll to try and save him. So this guy back here is dead. But
I'm done shooting, so.
I might be able to reanimate him on two fives.
Oh nice.
What do I want him? I guess I'll focus him over here.
Mega scrap, I can't say it. Mega track scrap chest gonna fire. He's gonna put his wing missiles, or wing missile into this guy here. He's plus one hit in the last one for the trees. And then the rocket cannon and the twin big shooters are going after them.
Let's guard, all right.
Twin big. So the wing missiles is one missile launcher. It's plus one to hit against vehicles, and then minus one because the tree, so it misses.
It does miss, yeah. The trees protect. And then the
rocket cannon is 2d3 shots.
It's just rockets, I assume?
It's exactly so that, yeah.
Four rocket shots.
Fives to hit the lich guard. Real quick, do you mind if I do a reroll on the
I don't mind.
Yeah, because that's where
yeah,
I should have
hit it. Yeah, okay,
it didn't misses. Matter.
Yeah.
And then we got one hit,
yep.
And we're wounding on a three.
That is a wound. AP is
minus three.
Minus two.
Yeah.
So four up save in the end. We are going to not put our shield up for that bad boy. And how much damage?
Three damage.
That's it for his shooting, though?
He's all done. Oh, no, big shooters.
Oh,
sorry.
Big shooter, yeah. So we're going to lose you, I guess, from the rocket.
It's a twin big shooter. So we're looking for fives to hit them. Sixes are an extra shot.
Yeah, they are.
I've already used a reroll. We're wounding on four, so your toughness is good. I haven't used a reroll yet here, so I'll use it now. So we have three wounds. There's no AP though.
So two up save on them. We're okay. That's it for shooting. So let's see if we can reanimate that poor chap. No, not quite. He's dead.
This guy's gonna fire. I'm trying to pick profiles here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna target the Lich Guard and I'm gonna fire a squig launcher with the small gun and a heavy squig launcher with the big gun, which is gonna be functionally the same. Only one does one shot, one does two. So we're gonna roll them all together, keep it simple. We're hitting on fives. We're gonna reroll because we're death skulls. Of course, and we're gonna get another shot because it's a six. And then we're going to be wounding on fives because they're all strength five. And we haven't wounded, or sorry, wounding on fours. We're going to reroll one. So we got one at minus three.
Minus three, shield up. We're good.
All good.
And we have this dude with his, I assume, big shooters?
Yes. Oh, no, they're different because I think they're 18-inch range guns. I want to start hurting them a little bit. He'll have six shots.
With his guns?
Yeah. Okay, so we're hitting on six, so we advanced.
Right.
We might as well use a reroll. No. All right, we're done. It's time to charge.
Oh boy, here we go. Okay, we're done shooting. We survived shooting. I took a lot more damage on that than I should have. That I would have hoped. I have four wounds remaining. So one hit from him will take him out.
I am going to spend two command points
Ooh.
For ramming speed.
Ah, 3d6 charge on him, eh? How many wounds that guy got?
Ooh, 8 or 9. It's in that area.
I will overwatch with the monolith into that. It's a 3d6 charge. Take all three dice.
All three dice.
So the average.
And he has here we go.
Right, exactly. So he just needs to roll a 10, like a 10 is the average on three dice, so he should be able to make it. I'm gonna go ahead and try and do some damage with the monolith before it gets caught up here real bad. Starting with the particle whip, it's again heavy d6. Two shots, that's cool. And 6 to hit. Oh, not a hit there, that's okay. And we got a bunch of shots with the rapid fire gun. What would have happened if it was still 4 though? Nothing, good. Good to know. Here's all the Gauss Flux Arcs. Rapid fire 3 now on that gun. I hope to get a little bit of damage out here, and by a little bit, we got 2 hits. Which, strength, toughness on him is probably...
Toughness...
6-ish? Well, you know
what? It's gonna be 3's the wound.
No, this is only strength 5 gun.
Oh, so. Is it strength 5? Yeah, it should be 3's the wound. I'm toughness 6.
Yeah.
I meant to say 5. I'm thinking 5 in my head, but I'm saying 3.
We have 1 wounding hit. AP of 2, I believe.
AP of 2? 6 of save.
1 damage.
1 damage!
And with these stratagems, I'm down to 5 and Steve's down to 3 using ramming speed.
That's a 13-ish charge.
That's why. So Steve was too afraid of failing the charge here. I get it.
I'm going to wheel my back end up and I'm going to go tag them in a second. But on a 2 plus, it's always a 1.
Okay.
All right, so because if I already did 3 damage, I would have checked the gate.
Right.
If it couldn't kill me, I would have just forgot it and went over there.
Right.
But now I want it dead, so he's going to charge him.
Gotcha. All right, here's hoping he fail.
That's a fail. I'm going to here we go both of them.
Ooh.
Oh, no.
Interesting.
Okay, good.
Oh, that's an 8? Yeah, an 8's in.
We're going to go this way.
Yeah, that's 8's definitely in. It was actually only a 7-inch charge, I think. Boss is, of course, going to go first. It makes the most sense.
All right, he's got 6 attacks.
Hang on.
He's hitting on 2s, rerolling to hit because of his, I think it was Warlord Trait.
Yep.
And then...
He's strength 10?
He's strength 12.
12. 3's to wound.
And then rerolling to wound because of his relic.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
So 5
are minus 3?
So I have to make all 5 ups here. Not even close. He's dead. That's 4 damage because of the Warlord Trait. So, do I explode? Yes.
Love it!
That's not good for me.
Oh my god, I'm sorry, dude. Oh no.
I was debating on automatically blowing up, like, oh, I got like all these characters and everything nearby. Well, hopefully it'll roll low for me then. All units within 6 will suffer D6 mortal wounds. This could be bad in a lot of situations. I could kill both my characters off if I'm unlucky. If I'm unlucky. And at that point, it's just whatever. It's funny. It's the funny circumstances of the game. So I'll start with the most devastating ones. My Overlord is fine. He's got 1 wound left. My Lich Guard will lose 2.5 of them. So we'll lose you guys. And these are mortal wounds. They don't come back from that.
Oh, no.
Down to 1 wound there. And at this point, I forgot to show off my command protocols. The first one was Sudden Storm. It's the movement one. So my whole army would have bonus movement. Yeah, just for anyone who's curious.
I mean, even I knew that was going to be first.
Right, yeah. 1 wound there. Overlord is down to a wound, and then I got to roll 4 stuff back here as well. So I'll start with the Lord, because this is a scary one. I don't want to
Your warriors are fine.
I don't want to lose my Lord. Lord's dead. Spider dead.
Oh no!
And then Scarab's over here. Alive, surprisingly. Bloop. And I rolled a 5 on him, I think. Oof. Yeah, I just had to go double check his wounds. He is certainly dead. There, I got to say, folks, I have lost every, like, the narrative army games I brought. Something is cursed. And it's like the orcs. It's weird. It sounds mean to say it, but when playing against these orcs, it's like I'm not even playing the game. And I mean that not in a super negative way.
I'm so sorry. I roll so well. You roll pretty poorly.
I know.
Against these orcs.
I should have picked Protocol of the Eternal Guardian. I rolled a lot of 4s for my saves on the monolith. You know what? Might not have made a difference because I think you just did 12 damage.
I did 12 damage there at the end.
I believe there. So it might not have actually made a difference in the end, but. Man, yikes for sure. And you said the Necrons are fine over there, the warriors?
Yeah, those ones are fine, but my guys.
Well, let's see what we do to your war boss on bike. He's going to take 2.
Okay.
And then the...
He's got 5 left.
The Jumpa dragster.
He's 4, he's on 3.
So 3 left, and then he only takes 2. And then the monolith is le dead. That is certainly first strike if I've ever seen it. And then you can consolidate with him.
I'm good. Well, I guess we'll go that way.
Sure.
This guy will go ahead and grab them.
All right, throw your... Oh, I guess you can't attack them. But I will swing with those warriors. I'm going to pile in first, though. Just to show it off, I have 6 of them able to attack the...
Before you roll, I want to point someone out that there is a thing in this building, and most places have it, the Curse of the Freshly Painted Model. A freshly painted model does not do well in a bat rep.
Oh, this guy here.
That does not apply to orcs for some reason.
Yeah, orcs... Oh, I just feel like orcs have plot armor. Like, with Steve's orcs, is like... It's... Oh, like, this list has no... Like, it's a four-form list. Like, it's got, like, some shooting. It's got, like these guys, okay, let's put it this way, but they have, like, two shots each.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then they do 14 damage to my monolith between four shots.
Right.
It's just, and they hit on fours, fives.
Oh, those were threes and fours.
Yeah, these ones were fours. It's, like, it's still, and then, you know, like, that guy, oh, man, gets me every time.
I know.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, well, it is what it is. I got six attacks of those warriors on threes, and that was a miss. I knocked it over. No wounds. You're okay. You get to, oh, you don't get to fight back, but.
I'm stuck.
Yeah, that is all she wrote for over there. That should be it for the turn, too. Yes. Morale. Do I have any morale to do?
How's Luka's morale?
Once I started failing all the saves on the monolith from the shooting attacks, I'm like, it's one of those games. All right, let's do the motions, and we'll get to the end there. So the monolith isn't that important to my list, but the explosion kind of sucked.
The explosion was actually...
Yeah, once the explosion happened, I'm like, oh, of course the explosion happened. Like, without a doubt, the explosion is going to happen at this point.
I just feel so, like, you could still do well. I just feel so confident right now.
Right, yeah.
Like, I scored all three of my objectives.
Yes, I don't have any morale to do on my side. I know what you're saying. Well, Luke, you didn't have to put all your important stuff around the monolith. You know it could blow up. It's true.
It shouldn't have.
It's like him dying wasn't a guarantee, and then the 1 in 6 chance of him exploding. My initial plan was the monolith was going to cruise up on that side with the Lich Guard supporting. They were going to move up in this direction and go this way. But I couldn't deploy them all right here because then I would have been open to all of his entire army shooting into them if they wanted to be.
I feel like I went all in on the monolith because if I had failed to do that, if I didn't do that and you just went forward and kind of came out here, I would have been bogged down. I'd been fighting one or two of things at a time.
Yeah.
I would have been in a bad spot. But thankfully,
it worked out
very well.
Like this skewed so far into Steve's favor on this end because that was a massive gamble. If he had not killed the monolith, then he could have potentially lost the game, but put so far behind.
Uphill battle.
It would have been an uphill battle. So it was like a gamble that paid off.
No risk, no reward. It was medium risk for high reward.
Yeah, exactly. In this regard, it worked out quite well. And scoring, we'll show the objectives, but Steve got them all. He's on objective 2. He's on objective 5, and he's on 3 objectives right now. So that's gonna be technically 2 points because of the mission. The third point, and then this is worth 2. So it's gonna be 5 victory points plus first strike because he killed something in the first battle round of the game. So he's going to be at 6 victory points right away. These are the objectives I'm going to go for. I'm going to keep one secret from Steve here, and I'll show you guys later on. But 3 and 6 are the visible ones. Now, which one of these three do you want to give?
I'm going to just double check 3 real quick. 1 second.
He's going to make the bonus one the hidden one, which is smart because I can't do it.
See, I thought you might be trying that on me.
Yeah. I'm just going to reveal it now because it doesn't matter. I'm using it to be able to discard at the end of the morale phase. I don't want this is a dead card in my hand. I'll show you where it is. 4 is way over here in this corner with the Gretchen. I can't get to that in any feasible turn, or at least not in this turn. And then 3 is over there. 6 should be
right there.
Yeah, those are all going to be super easy for me to get. I'm only going to be getting 2 points. Oh, I'm going to get 3 to Steve 6, hopefully.
You get it for strike.
That'll be the third point.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, unfortunately. I was hoping you wouldn't get, you know, well, I mean, we're both going to get cards throughout this game. I'm going to be fine on points, I think. It's just...
One thing I want to point out, because I'm going to start thinking about it now, too. If you guys are watching this bat rep, start thinking about it. This list I made for, like, a 9th edition scenario.
This is supposed to do good in 9th edition?
Well, no. Nothing.
Oh, okay.
You get to understand something. When you play Orkz, you don't try to make a list for, like, good, because it's just going to do good. You're just going to roll what you need. You can bring crap, it's just going to work. It's Orkz. So it was meant to play 9th, but I'm thinking this might be really good for what the snares were doing. Good in 9th.
Everything's good in Maelstrom, which is the nice thing about Maelstrom. Everything can work because you build your deck around it, right?
Yeah, I think this is going to do very good for Maelstrom.
Right, like if you want to build, like, typically with Maelstrom, you have to have some scoring cards, but you can build it towards a very killy list. And this is typically what this is going to do. It's going to be very killy.
I guess I got to.
And fast.
I got to play with these more, I think.
Well, those things are amazing.
Yeah.
It's the, I like that one a lot more.
We have 2 of these and 1 of these, and I gotta buy another one of them and 2 more of them. I need to buy 9 of them. I wish I could upgrade all of them, but.
You wanna wait till a new codex, though, for sure.
I know, I don't wanna spend much money on this army right now.
Command phase, I do have some living metals to do. This Lich Guard's gonna heal the full. The Overlord's gonna go up to 2, and I forgot to mark the Scarab back here, but the Scarab is up to 3, who took 3 damage, or 2 damage. So you're back up to 3, buddy. And then I gotta do some My Will Be Dones, which will go on them. They get +1 to hit. And then the Lord over here is also going to choose them. I can't remember. The Lord's Will, I believe. It's reroll wound rolls of one.
Now, those last until your next command phase?
Yes.
Both of them? Okay.
Yeah. My apologies. The Lord's Will is reroll hit rolls of one, not wound rolls of one. Thinking of older rules from the last codex. Sort of, kind of, in a way. I will not be using the Resurrection Orb on three missing Lich Guard. I'm going to gamble a little bit and hopefully not lose seven in one go. No, not ideal. We do have Sudden Storm active currently for the Command Protocol, so we get plus one movement on things with Command Protocol rules near my characters, which is going to be simply these units mostly. None of this is going to get the extra movement from Sudden Storm. So we're going to start off by... I want to say these are going to fall back from combat. They're going to just move this direction 5 inches. Ending like that. These Necron Warriors are going to do a 5-inch move in this direction, but we are going to stay back at the maximum range we need to be. We're not going to be too worried about shooting our guns. We do have to be coherent to two models. We'll go ahead and touch the bases everywhere, so we don't have to worry about that too much. And there, I'm going to use them to get objective number 3. I think these ones are going to hang back here for a bit. I don't know, it's gonna be tough. I'll need them for sure. If these can't up to grades, I think I'm gonna do nothing. I think it's gonna stand still.
Okay.
They're gonna countercharge whatever shows up in this area, or at least attempt to. Okay. Lich Guard are gonna move. They do get to move 7 for Relentless March and Sudden Storm. I'm gonna go ahead and do just that. I'm gonna have you come over in this direction. And you're gonna move to about there. And then we'll do this. Is there one more? Oh, there is one more. The last one, already measured, can go right there. So they're going to be coherent, but I need a lane for the Overlord to get in, because I'm obviously going to do the honorable route and have my Overlord do it. Gosh. Now, Overlords move 6 base. They don't get anything from Relentless March, but they do get Sudden Storm. So he's going to go 7. He's going to take his 2 wounds there. And then the Lord is going to follow along. Sorry, he's over there. He'll move about there with a 7-inch move. And the Scarabs, they are probably going to advance. Would like a high roll here. Hey, not bad. They go 16 inches. They do have fly. They're all going to fly over the trees, over the models, landing there. Not really doing too much else with their turn, though. Necron Warriors are going to go up against the tree here. Maybe the tree will help protect them a little bit. And they're just going to take some random pot shots. They're kind of happy hiding back here as much as they can. Not all of them will be rapid firing, but I don't really need their help anyways. It's going to be one of the few things I have that actually shoot. With that... that will be it. Now, this is the only unit that's going to be firing, because everything else is a close combat weapon. Again, the Kaffir Dynasty is not too concerned about that. We are going to go mess things up in close combat, though. They're not able to shoot because they fell back. One is rapid firing, the rest are not, so it's going to be 11 shots into the buggy. Looking for 3s to hit it. No negatives there. Got a few misses, all 1s, though. And no rerolling for that. And these should be 5s, 2, and 3 wounds at AP 1.
5 up. Ooh, still alive with 1.
Got 1 wound left. Did they blow up by chance?
You know what? I don't know the answer to that.
Okay.
If they do, it's be 1.
Okay, well, I'm a little concerned for my Overlord's life here, but you know what? What are the chances of 2 things exploding? It is the D3 mortal wounds
on 3 inches.
So I think it's kind of close there that I'm within 3, but I gotta consider that when I charge, and I might not even care. Who would mind that, right? Now, I'm gonna go right on a charging right now. This is all the charges I have to do. We are gonna start with the Overlord declaring a charge against your war boss. Yeah, absolutely.
You have 2 up save?
3 up.
Oh, Luka!
I'll do it all day.
Oh, I got 3 command points.
I'll do this charge all day
long. Oh, it's not likely, but I could.
You could.
I want 4 command points next turn.
I know you do.
All right, not doing it. I'm going to roll it.
But you're gonna roll it anyways. You gotta know. Got you. All right.
Yeah, 6 is a hit.
Oh no, that's
rerolling a hit. 2 more shots.
Okay.
And 4s to wound. Rerolling a wound.
Okay.
Rolling
hit.
2, 3. Roll 3.
This is all make believe, though. We are okay.
Yeah, you're fine. Yeah.
That's what I thought. It was a good call not to do it. We are gonna charge this far though. 6 inches. 6 is going to take us to there. We're going to try to use a pile-in to get outside of the 3 inches for the potential explosion. We are going to have the Lord declare a charge against the buggy, though. Would you like to overwatch there?
Ooh.
Nah. Okay. Charging. 10. Well, we all know that's good. He will not be able to avoid the explosion, as he will go in and take the honors. Now, the Lich Guard are going to declare a charge against both targets. They are going to get an 8. I'm content with this. This is all I've got going on. So we are going to fight first with the Necron Overlord in honorable combat against the Orc Warboss here, who has 5 remaining wounds, and I got the Void Scythe. The Overlord here is definitely going to engage in honorable combat.
I'll tell you right now, just to be cool, when you don't kill me and interrupt, I will only fight him, because it's honorable combat.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So we hit on 2s with the 2 extra attacks. We reroll hit rolls of 1 because we're warrior nobles. All right. And then your toughness goes... Oh, what's your toughness on him? 7?
7.
So it goes down to 6. So I'm strength 7. Mm-hmm. So this is 3s to wound with rerolling 1s to wound because of warrior nobles. And these are no save. No one, AP4, no involuntary save. That's 15 damage.
It was close.
It was super close. Right? Oh, I forgot to... I'm going to pile in a little bit too. Okay, so... While he was still there, I purposely didn't touch his base so I could pile up and close
to there
and stay outside of 3 inches of him. And we touched his base when we charged in case he interrupted so that I could not get within 3 inches. He's not dying to some explosion here. Now, is this thing actually good in combat?
It's not bad.
Fair.
It's not worth spending 2 command points on.
Okay, then I will go with my Lord next because he's only got 1 wound, eh? Honorable combat, the Lich Guard stand aside, let the nobles do the work, obviously. The Lord only has 3 attacks with his War Scythe on 2s, rerolling 1s because of warrior nobles. It's like the only way to make them a little, even then. toughness is...
Oh, you know what? I forgot the trick for you. I'm sorry. It's toughness 6.
Well, the 2 fails, and I get to reroll the 1. Warrior noble. Thank you. It's AP 4.
Okay.
You get your 6 up invuln save, though.
That's true. I am Death Skulls!
This is a regular War Scythe.
No.
That's 2 damage.
Explode!
No. Unless the 1s count for him, for whatever
for
reason.
Yeah, for Death Skulls.
No, for the Shock Jump Dragster, obviously. All right. So we cleared them out. Not too bad. That was in retaliation. But that is Warlord kill and first strike for me. So I do get points for that, which
is nice.
Yes, sir. So he is then going to consolidate afterwards and end up there, getting closer to this general area. Now the Lich Guard, I have to do this carefully, but they're going to try and pile in and consolidate to get on this side of the Overlord. That should, in the end, no matter what, always get them closer to the models in that direction. We'll see if I can pull that off, though. I'm going to take this wound off him because it's going to be in the way. Easily able to pull that off, that guy consolidating and piling it this way and getting closer to him by like tenths of an inch or quarters of an inch every time. So that is where that's going to end up. No morale to do. I am going to go on to scoring, but I'm going to discard the secure objective 4 card, I think. Yeah, there's no real reason for me to really want to go for it right now. We are going to discard that. That's gone. But we do score this one and this one. That's 2 points because none of those are the Ambitious Surge. And for First Strike and Slay the Warlord, it gets me an extra couple points. So I'm actually at 4 to Steve's 6. Not that bad. This time I'll actually show you my command protocol. So let's go from Sudden Storm to Hungry Void. So I have to choose a directive here. It's either I get additional AP or I get additional strength. Obviously, when you go for additional strength, the AP is not going to matter against orcs. I have such high AP. There's nothing with more than a... I don't think you have anything with a 2-up save over there, do you? I don't care about that. He's got 4-up involved. So yeah, we're going to go directive 2. Each time, the first round of combat, I get extra strength on anything near characters. Command phase, especially playing Maelstrom of War, not that active for orcs, I guess.
Yeah.
I guess you just get a command point.
Get a command point, nothing else really to do.
You're up to 4 now.
Yep.
We can put your cards down, though. We can figure out your cards.
I did that already.
All right, so we're going to throw them over here. It's a little bit cleaner. So we have a mystery one. No prisoners, which is kill something. If you kill between 3 and 5 units, you get 2 points. And if you kill 6 or more, you get at that point, I've lost horribly. We get 3 plus, so you get 5 victory points if you do that. Hold the line is score a victory point if you have at least 3 units completely within your deployment zone. That'll be super easy for him to do. No prisoners is probably going to be easy for him to do. Because those are both so easy, I'm going to say this is your surge. This is the one you have to accomplish. Now, you don't have to reveal it. I chose to reveal mine because I was going to discard it anyways. So
keep it.
That's the one you get extra points if you accomplish.
Okay.
And I'm pretty sure you're getting these ones no matter what. So hopefully the same ploy works for you as it did for me. I doubt it, but we'll see. Because it's orcs. It's Steve's orcs. This is probably like the easiest objective in the world. I did kind of forget to show it off, but the 2 objectives I scored were secure objective 3 and secure objective 6 by the trees over there. So I might not have to worry about those anymore.
All right, everybody. So I was going to go all in on this side of the table right now. I actually had some ideas to deal with this.
Okay.
Now, I was going to cripple this, but you were going to keep, I wasn't going to get him, which meant Luka was going to use his Resorb, bring many of these Lich Guard back, and then have that Strength 8 War Scythe tear me apart.
Right.
So instead, I'm going to pull back.
Okay.
Go reserve for a turn and have Luka waste his plus one strength scythe.
You can do that. You get the mobility because to do that.
Now that it's gone from Luka's thing, like he's got, like, I'm going to make sure he can't charge me, and now my toughness 8 vehicles are going to go.
That means you might not. Well, I guess you can still kill something with shooting.
I'm thinking I'm going to deal with these two units still.
Sure. Okay. Yeah. Ideally, Steve wants to kill something for no prisoners. Actual movement.
This one's simple. This one's coming here. Okay. Give me a second here. Oh, wait, we're pulling to here.
That's the weird drill one.
We're pulling to here.
Backing on up.
And we're gonna go this way. Guys, I'm not sure if Gaz, which way he's going. If I decide he's going that way, he's gonna move before this, but I know where he's gonna go after him, so I'm just gonna move him now, just keep it simple.
Okay.
This guy's pulling back as well. Actually, you can go back all the way to there. Now I gotta figure.
You just want to see where those were gonna look like where they were ending up first before.
Well, I knew that was happening. And I didn't want to, so I was gonna do that for
he's
sure.
He's just gonna move last, but
he might end up over here.
Okay.
Yeah, Gaz is gonna advance. He's going the other way.
He's going through the Corkanot.
He's gonna go. They moved first.
Yeah.
Shock jump. Drake is gonna advance.
Off the table.
Yeah.
Is he showing up near the raids? Boom. Right there, eh? Sacrificial unit?
It might have been a hidden objective.
Ooh.
This guy here is going to go first.
Shooting time.
Yes, in the shooting phase. We're going to put rockets into the Scarabs.
Okay.
Gatling gun into these warriors, the big gun of the warriors. Flamer, actually, not in range. And the two twin big shooters also into these guys.
The warriors in the back, okay.
Let's do the rockets first. Reroll a hit because we're...
Death skulls.
Oh, two hits.
Nice.
Two's the wound.
Should be twos, yeah.
Reroll a wound.
And I get no save against that.
Minus two, so three damage.
It's three damage. It kills the one, and then the other one goes down to one wound. First three damage kills this scarab off. And then we're going to have... I don't know if it matters too much. At least my brain's not thinking of anything big right now. We'll have that one go down to one for now. Coherency might be an issue. Oh, you know what? I actually had to... bring that one back in. Sorry about that, everyone. Had to be within range of two models. I forgot they have a big unit. So if anyone pointed that out, you're right. They just had to end up like that instead of how they were.
Gatling gun on fives. And he hits at least sixes over here.
Oh, nice.
We already rerolled a hit.
Correct. And you rerolled a wound as well.
We have five sixes. Ooh, nice.
Yeah, that's orc shooting.
Strength six, so threes to wound. And was that in?
That's 7-4 up saves. Oh, making about half, so I fail four, so four are dead so far, and I'm pulling from the back.
And two twin big shooters. I should have spent them on these guys. 1-6, that's a four.
Oh, with the Mordaka.
Yeah. And a three is two wounds, so four more, no rend.
I have to go back, and so four, more than four might be dead of the warriors, because I thought Steve was doing the twin big shooter first, that's why I said the four up save, but this is the twin big shooter. The Gatling gun is rend AP1, so I have to go double check that. So I only had a five up save against that, so I fail one of these. So that's three dead warriors, so far seven dead, but there might be a couple more. Which is unfortunate, because I only rolled 1-5 up. There's only nine left here, so that seven that died, I actually failed two more saves. I have no cover or anything I can claim here, because they're too far away from that building. I think I'm going to have to re-roll one of the saves on the twin big shoot and hopefully get a four up to keep one model alive and then attempt to reanimate them. Otherwise, they're all dead. So I'll go down to five command points and hopefully get a four up here. I do. Nice. So I got one guy left alive.
He's all done.
Eight. So I'm going to keep the guy with the golden head alive, I think. Yeah, we'll keep him alive. So eight of them just got shot down there. Fives to reanimate. Rerolling any ones. We're only really getting one back. Oh, this is a poor showing.
Oh.
This is a super poor showing for Necrons, folks. Very good orc shooting. Very good. Four. Only seven dice. I got one guy does reanimate. We'll reanimate him over here.
This guy's going to go next. And what is he going to do is he's going to use bile squigs for both guns. So one does 2d6 shots, one does d6 shots.
Okay, gotcha.
And other than that, they all wound on fours. So we're going to have a total of 10 attacks.
Yep.
Fives to hit. We're going to do it. We're going to do a reroll. Stink.
Yeah, one reroll.
And then we have a six. Finish your shot. Oh, he's always wound on fours, unless you're a vehicle.
Oh, it's like a weird
poison. We're going to do a reroll a wound. So we got four. No rend.
No rend. No AP.
You're fine.
Oh, well, they tank it. Okay, well, a little bit more firepower is going to have to go into them if you want to take them out.
Gaz is going to go next, shooting at these two warriors.
I messed up. I should have pulled the gold helmet guy.
Six is to hit.
Two hits.
Two more shots.
They could have been out of line of sight. Just two hits.
Could they have been?
Oh, no, he doesn't get the culture, right?
He does not. But he would have been Lancehead no matter what, right?
I could have chose to pull him and kept the guy closer to the Lich Guard. Yeah. Okay. That's, I could have kept him behind the building more.
Three. Okay, I am going. Oh.
No. He doesn't get the clan culture, does
no,
he?
He's not a Death Skull. He's
so one wounding hit?
Minus one.
We're not okay. We lose that warrior. We're gonna take.
I'm done.
Yeah, we're gonna take the guy with the golden helmet. On a five, he's back up. Reroll the one for endless legion. He's done. And then what I should have done is had that guy die, kept the guy that was there, and then this guy could have reanimated over there. But in this case, this guy's kind of placed him willy nilly. I thought they'd be dead. I didn't expect there'd be a chance they could survive this. Like when my monolith dies to everything, but like somehow nine Necron warriors are hard to kill.
Bonebreaker's next, he's gonna shoot at those two warriors. He only has two big shooters, all I can afford for points. So we're hitting on fives. We're gonna get the reroll a hit. Nope, and then extra shot for the six, which also hit. Three is to wound. Reroll a wound. Death Skulls, man. Four. AP.
He's gonna at least get cover, which isn't gonna matter. Ooh, he dies just. Womp womp. Bad. Gave Steve a point there. Shouldn't have. Sorry, folks.
Scrap Jets is next. Everything to the Scarabs.
All missiles, wing missiles, regular missiles. Does this have wing missiles and regular missiles?
He has, regular one wing missile and 2d3 regular
missiles.
They
do have the fly keyword.
It doesn't matter.
Oh.
Okay, so we're going to do the big shooter first. So we're hitting on fives. Extra shot for the six. And we're going to be wounding on, I think it's five, twos. He toughest two?
T3.
Oh, okay, threes. You know, just no rend, no AP.
So they got two up. So six up. Sorry, two. So that's two damage so far. Well, one's dead, one takes a wound. Before I kill this guy off, I forgot to reanimate the one that died to a missile earlier. Not even close. So chances are it wasn't going to work anyways, but I forgot to reanimate.
Oh, sure. There's only one wound.
Yeah, this guy's going to go down to. It should be two. This guy's got three wounds left.
Yeah. Next is going to be a wing missile. It's minus one to hit because you're not a vehicle.
Oh.
Okay, it misses. And then the rocket cannon is 2d3 shots. We're gonna have four shots. This is gonna be fives to hit. We're gonna reroll a hit, and then we get extra shot for the six.
Stacker.
And then we're wounding on twos. We'll reroll one of these, and I wanna see if it's worth it. No, command point would just kill one more scarab, not worth it.
Okay, so this one's gonna die, they're three damage, right?
Yeah.
So that one's dead, and then this one's going down to one wound remaining.
But I'm done, so you can go ahead and
attempt a reanimate. Well, I'm just gonna roll, I got four dice here, I'll roll it twice. So I've gotten 1-6 so far. Oh, off by one. So they're both dead.
Mordecai's gonna go next. I'm gonna fire the scarabs. And does the resurrection orb work on the scarabs?
I don't know. I'll go look it up.
This guy's gonna Mordaka into the scarabs with everything. Ooh. Twin big shooters. Oh, jeez.
Yeah, that's the orc shooting. They hit on fours because he's a.
Oh, right, he's on fours. Okay, but it's five more
shots.
Attacks.
Yeah, because of more Daka. So Steve's down to two command points now.
And goodness. And we're wounding on threes.
Yep.
Three, six, eight, no rend.
No AP on that, so six up save. Okay, that's two dead so far. That's eight damage so far. One guy's got one wound left.
We'll do belly gun next. Misses. I'm gonna use my reroll here.
Okay. More die. Yep.
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
Okay. And then the big gun.
Two 3d3 shots.
Ooh, loving it.
Is this blast by chance?
I don't know. That's a good question.
It doesn't matter because you got more than three anyways. You can't get
right.
You can't get
any.
If that was an 11 squad of scarabs, which it can't be, then it would matter.
We're hitting on fours. We're gonna use a reroll.
Right.
Ooh.
That's kind of a whiff.
Ooh. Okay. Two's the wound. We're gonna use a reroll. And do six damage.
It kills the one wound guy, yeah. Eight damage, that one takes one. This is from the twin big shooter. And then seven more damage, so that's four, five, six, seven, down to one. And then the big gun just finishes it off. So I have to reanimate three of them. Throwing 12 dice at this? Yeah, sorry guys. Kind of poopy stuff. Should've got one back there, actually. But at least they're both at full health.
Well, we're gonna put the shock jump dragster into them as well.
All right, he's got the weird rail guns.
Okay, so he advanced, so he's hitting on fours.
Yep.
With his custom shock rifle. To his extra shot. we're gonna use our reroll on that. Oh, okay. We're gonna be wounding on twos. We're gonna use our reroll on that. And it's gonna be minus three.
So D6 damage one at a
time. So the first one.
Oh, you're a monster.
Second one.
Equally big monster. That's orc shooting for you, folks. The army's just playing itself at this point.
And the rest of the shots are wasted.
Yeah. Oh, maybe. Maybe people at home are having a laugh.
I'm done, that's my turn.
With that, there's no charging, there's no fighting, no morale to do, so we can go right on to scoring. No, we get no prisoners for one because he killed two units. Shy by one for the 2 points. Hold the line you got with the Gretchen and vehicles alone. And then this one did you get?
Sure, objective one.
Right, that's where you jumped onto?
Yeah.
So you get 2 points for that, 3, 4 more points, putting you at 10. Gear objective one is over here. So I do have the Necron cards, I'm playing with them, obviously. So we have Slaughter of the Living, which is just kill something. Area Denial, which is if there is no enemy units within 6 inches of the center of the battlefield at the end of my turn, I get a victory point. Or 2 victory points if they're not within 12. They're not within 6 right now, so I'll automatically get a point for that, unless I somehow drag them in there. And then one mystery one, that's the word. Which one is the aggressive surge?
It's this one here. I know you can do it.
Right.
But for you to guarantee to do it, you have to risk something.
Well, I was going to do that no matter what. Risk the raise?
Yeah.
Risk the raise, yeah. I'm going to, well, at this point, in my mind, there's no point in being cautious. And like I said, my deck is mostly about killing stuff, so I am going to have to go for that. I get it. And then this one, for anyone who's curious, it is that. Now, into my command phase, which I got nothing to do over here.
He heals again.
Yeah, he's going to heal up to 3 wounds. I think I just moved it, actually. Oh. He's at 3 wounds right now, though.
He needs to go back up to 4 before I get to him.
Hopefully. Might will be done on the Lich Guard, and then the Lord's will also go on the Lich Guard, because only thing really in range. So they get to reroll hit rolls 1, and they get +1 to hit. I got to rethink my position I'm in right now. I also go up to 6 command points remaining. It's going to be for my command phase, so these Necron Warriors are going to move their 5 inches. I think I want them to start popping out over here. We're going to have this tree and those trees kind of collectively protect them, I think, will be the goal here. Just going to poke their heads out and around, so in case anything gets too close, maybe I can move forward and rapid fire next turn. They're here as compulsory troop choices. You know how it is, folks. Heresy folks, you know. These Necrons are going to move forward 5 inches as well. In this direction, they're going to be shooting at that guy. Coming over here. Like that, and of course the raids are going to come out of here and they're going to go jump on this guy, because why not? So it's kind of like it's a gambit, obviously. I'm going to hope that they can just draw a lot of firepower and just with their 4 up and vulnerable saves can just tank it. Now I don't know what to do with the Lich Guard and the Overlord as of yet, so it's kind of one of those, I kind of want them to show up, these guys to show up, and I want my Lich Guard to show up on the table as well and just put pressure on 3 different points so that Steve can't focus fire down one thing. But I know it's not going to work, but I'm going to try it anyways. The Wraiths are going to jump through using Wraith Form to phase through the building and up there. Go over here and put a wound marker on the Overlord, and we are going to, like, begrudgingly try and figure something out here. We're going to move them 6, and yes, I know what you're thinking. Well, why? Why? Well, I don't know. So here we go. We're just going to hope this works out for us. They're going to move their 6 inches. We're going to try and make it so... Oh, I wanted to keep a couple behind cover, so I might... Maybe these guys can just tank some of the shots for me again. Like the little piddly shots, you know? The little piddly shots. And then we're going to do Overlord. We're going to advance both the Overlord and the Lord. The Overlord I'm not too concerned about. He already moved 6. He probably can make it there with an advance. This guy's going to have to die with me. That'll get you right into there as well. And you're at 3 wounds. You're going to hang back there. You're going to hang back there. You should be within 2 of him. You're within 2 of them. Yeah, everyone is good-ish, except you guys should be within 2 of each other as well. Difficult thought I'm having here with the Lich Guard is I could show up about here. Now on the second turn, I can't show up anywhere in Steve's deployment zone or his table side, which is the short one over here. I could show up like, I think it's like around here. I could use the trees to protect against like a -1 to hit, and then I could try and charge him, which will help us slaughter the living, because there's almost a guaranteed kill there. Then we get this guy here, which is not ideal. Or I could try and show up on the other side of that building, which will support the nobles and everything, and make it a little awkward for all of them to shoot at them. I could attempt to charge at the squig buggy, but then puts me right out in the open, and killing that doesn't actually accomplish me anything. Now, I'm not super confident in their killing potential on this buggy here, so it's either I go here with a -1 to hit, or I try and hide behind that building and support them a little bit more over there. I think I'm going to go over there. Yeah, I'll do that. Well, this is where they're at. Steve could decide just to kite them for the rest of the game, and if he does that, well, he does that. I just feel like it's better than them standing over here and getting annihilated, charging him and getting annihilated, standing over there and probably still died of shooting. Over here, at least he has to move into a weirder position to get line of sight. Like, everything has to be right there. Maybe that'll be harder to do. I don't know. Maybe I'm just imagining things. We'll find out, though. We're going to the shooting phase now. These Necron Warriors are going to do 10 shots into the Shock Jump Dragster.
Jing.
One of them is going to be a -1 to hit. Shooting through the trees. Yikes. The one that's -1 to hit misses anyways. The rest on threes One miss, okay. Five is to wound. Oh wow, five wounds, AP one.
Five up. We take four, we're down to four.
All right, down to four. Okay, now I'm a little more confident in their killing potential. So I'm happier with my decision of putting the Lich Guard over there because it was, you know, like if they made the charge to kill it, then I'm still gonna die. So it's not great. That's it for shooting though. They're gonna go ahead and declare a charge against him. I assume you do not want to overwatch.
No, sir. I only have two?
You should have two, yeah. 10. Go maul up this vehicle some. That being the only charge, we'll go ahead and start swinging with them. They only hit on fours now, but they got a lot of attacks. I think they have four attacks each. Fours to hit with their vicious claws. Pretty good. The rad wreath won't work here because, you know, it's a vehicle. So we're still going to be wounding on fours to follow up. Because it's only T6?
Yes.
Fours. No, not that it matters. Only a couple threes in there. That should be more than enough to kill it. These are AP 2, 2 damage each. So the 5, 10 wounds. 10 wounding hits.
Let's go. We're dead.
Oh, yeah. Does he explode?
Ah. It's not meant to be, Luka. It's not meant to be, brother.
All right, lost a rate. Sigh.
Just not meant to be.
Everything is such a struggle. That will be the end of my turn there. Not too shabby, not too shabby at all. So no morale, on to scoring. I get 2 points for Slaughter of the Living because that's the one Steve declared. I get 1 point for Area Denial, and I get 1 point for securing back objective one that thing was on. So I get 4 points on my turn, putting me at 8. Steve, good job. Hungry Void, gone. Burnt that one, that was a good call. And we got Undying Legion now. I get to, whenever I use Living Metal, I heal one additional wound, or each time I make a reanimation protocol roll for a unit near a character, I get to reroll one of the dice. I'm not gonna be able to benefit from either of these that well. I'm just gonna go with that one. So whenever the Lich Guard gets shot, I get to reroll one of the dice. Alrighty, so we have Secure Objective 5, Secure Objective 1, and a Mystery 1. Let me see where 5 is, but I'm probably...
5's right here. I'm already on it.
Okay, so 5 is way over there.
1's your Wraiths.
Yeah. I'm going to say you have to get number 1.
Okay.
This one, I don't know what that is, but we're going to say you get number 1. That's the 2-point one. Steve also gets a command point, going back up to 3 in the command phase, and we're right on the movement.
We're going to advance. Okay, it's 11. We got to start sending this way.
This is where they end up.
We're gonna go to here.
Gorkonaut.
But.
Gorkonaut, I mean.
This guy here is gonna advance.
The War Trike dude. He doesn't automatically go with 6, eh?
I wonder if he does. Actually, I just realized I didn't need to advance.
Oh, okay. He's gonna go to Objective 2. No advancing?
What? Yeah. Big boy's gonna advance.
A 5! Very good.
Ooh!
And with that big move, he's gonna back it up, and then we're just facing him that way. He technically be backwards, but that looks silly.
Gazcool is going to, okay, here's the funny thing. He's gonna go ahead and advance, because what he's now doing is, you have no shooting here other than that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
He's just gonna get stuck in.
If I just put him here to block, it'll take a look at the rest of the game to kill him, so long as I can kill them. This guy's gonna advance. I gotta change his movement. Right there. This guy's just gonna back up. There's my little trick range. I'm gonna have to go a little forward. He's a forward. So he's gonna go.
Just there. Enough to get range?
Yeah.
Yeah. Of the warriors in the back there.
And finally, this guy's gonna go. And. Go there.
Protect the Morkanot at all costs.
Yes. We're starting first right here. We're gonna put everything into those Necron Warriors just to keep guys so we can hold the line, except for my rockets and my belly gun have to go that way because there's no other targets.
Right, okay. So you just wanna shoot at them first then?
You know.
Or shoot at
them. I think I got them. How many? The only 3 wounds each, right?
3 wounds apiece, yeah.
Between those two guys, they should have you. I'll do it. Rockets.
Okay.
5's to hit. I'm going to do a reroll on this.
Should it not be 4's to hit?
4's to hit. Yeah. And then 3's to wound.
Oh, yo.
4 pinball.
Here's 2 fails coming right up. Oh, he failed one!
3 damage.
That's 1 dead race so far.
Belly gun on a 4. And a 3.
And save.
Okay.
Is that it for him? Shooting at them?
Yeah, then we're going to do the other guns.
And we don't reanimate him. So he's dead.
So now we got the the big shooters. It's going to be minus one because of trees, so we're hitting on fives.
Right.
But that's ridiculous.
That's a good rule.
Two more shots for sixes.
But, I mean, that's the synopsis of the game.
Threes to wound. Yeah. We have not used a reroll, so we'll use it here.
Sure.
There we go. I shouldn't have used it there. That was dumb. So we have seven.
Start by putting on the two guys here behind cover. And you have seven of them, you said. Mm-hmm. No rend, so three ups. Three ups.
Ooh, nice.
Ooh, double dead. Dead. And then no one else is really in cover from those shots, so I have one more. Four up. Okay, we're good.
Big gun, 3d3 shots. Oh, not that many.
Oh, not quite max, but minimum three. I think it has to be 11 or more. They're only 10 man units.
Five is the hit. We already used a reroll. And extra shot for six.
Yep.
And then two's to wound. And this is minus three.
Minus three, no save, so just two more dead.
Yeah. And he's out shooting.
And then we have four reanimation protocols to roll four here. Five ups. Reroll the ones. We get two back. Very nice. I'll put them just back
in cover.
Back in cover, yeah. Is there anything else I can feasibly shoot at them?
Yeah, I got this guy. He's on sixes.
Right.
He's going to do very well as he shoots at him. And that's all it has range to them.
I think against him, I'm going to have a couple more guys in cover. So I'm going to just reanimate you there and reanimate you there.
I don't have a lot of command points. I was thinking about using ramming speed for this guy. For multiple reasons, mortal wounds. Oh, it's a large. I gotta save it for ramming speed. All right, okay. He's not gonna do daga.
Okie dokie. Who's he firing at then?
Warriors, same one.
Everything?
Just stuff that's in range.
The flamer will go there.
The flamer and the missiles will go there, and everything else will go there.
Okay. There won't be any negative one to hits for anything here, so just all fives. Is this the big gun?
This is the big gun. This is the one with the AP. So, fives to hit.
Sixes are good. We gotta see three sixes. Extra rolled average.
More on the average. No extra half to sixes. Do I want to use a reroll here? Yeah, I do. Reroll to hit. Misses.
The death skulls.
And then wounds on threes. I'm going to use a reroll to hit. Or to
reroll
here.
The wound, yeah. So five wounds. My three guys, maybe four in cover. I got that guy's within three of the tree. So these are all minus ones, so back up to four ups. And we're starting from the back and working our way up. So we failed three of them, so we got that one guy left there. And he's dead as well, so he just guns down these four. Was that? No, he's got more shots.
He's got more shots. Big shooters, or two big shooters, sorry. It's on fives. No, there we go, more like average. One more shot for the six. And threes. No rend.
These are all four ups. Okay, one more dice.
He's done. Well, he's done on them if I rolled it down.
Yeah, they were missing five models, so reanimating fives.
Womp, womp, womp. And then we got two rockets, and then flamer is going to be one hit that does not wound.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? I already rolled a wound. Never mind. That's right. This guy is going after them.
Everything to them.
Okay, so.
3d6
shots. 3d6
shots.
We're going to move that one. It's going to be only five shots.
Right.
Six is the hit.
We got four hits. And four more daka. Steve gets more upset about it than I do.
I'm sorry. Somehow.
It's a farce.
I had five
it's just
shots
a joke.
Six is going to six.
It's literally just a meme. It doesn't even matter.
Three's two. And here's his reroll.
Oh, that's fair, yeah.
Six damage, no rend.
No AP?
No AP.
Four ups! They're dead.
I don't even know how that doesn't make sense.
It's here rolling dice and moving models, my man.
This doesn't make sense at all. Scrap Jets going after the raids.
Bring it on. Lots of missiles.
All right.
No vehicles here, though.
2d3.
Ooh.
Three.
Five.
Oh, goodness.
That's a pretty good start.
Hitting on sixes as we advanced. I'm going to use a reroll.
Sure.
And then the other missile hits on sixes. And then two big shooters. One twin big shooter, sixes, and we're done.
Okay.
His two big shooters, sixes, because he advanced. I'll use a reroll. Extra shot. Okay. Fours to wound. Use a reroll. Just one.
We are okay. And we got Gazgul Thraka.
We're just going to go after, let's split it. Let's put it under them.
Sure.
On sixes, because he advanced. And then two more shots, and fours to wound, one rend.
We are okay.
You're fine.
That's it for shooting. We're on to the charge phase.
Pretty good. Let's do, because of his aura, he can advance and charge.
Correct.
So he's going to go ahead and use two command points for
ramming speed. So you're down to one. And, wow, that's good enough.
89? Yeah, that should be enough. You know what? For some reason, I thought they both fit. There's no way he's going to fit. So.
Which one do you want in more then? Probably him, I guess.
Yeah.
So more wounds on a two up.
Two up.
It works.
Oh, got one.
It's perfect. It's perfect. We'll just remove you.
Got the upgrade for the red roller, so he has 12 attacks on the charge.
Of course.
Hitting
don't leave
twos.
Home without it.
We're going to reroll one with Death Skulls. Oh, didn't help. And this is strength 9? So, wait, 8 or 9, I think it's 9. 3 is to wound. We're going to use the reroll. Oh, didn't help.
No.
So, 3, 6, 8.
Invulnerables. Hey. Ooh, how much damage are these?
2 each.
Oh, okay. Well, I lost 3 of them to like, I lost 2 to more wounds than 1.
Oh, sorry, I just want to go for, I want to see if I can get to that, right? So I'm going to go for 3. And then I think you didn't all die, but I was still
Yeah, they're not all dead. Yeah, you got to try anyways. Yeah. So we are going to go ahead with, just leave it as is. I'm not going to use a command point reroll here. Do I? So wait, that's going to be 1 dead. And then, no, it doesn't matter. Yeah. So you'll die. And then you're going to go down to 1 wound. And then that should be it for his attacks.
That's it.
So reanimating that guy potentially, but no. And we're not near any characters for Undying Legion. 1 wound left. And then that's pretty much it. So
that's it.
Let's go ahead and just fight back, because why not? If they both, you know, don't want to fall over on me. There we go. Hitting on 4s. Okay, cool. And 5s.
3 oh, wounds. Nice.
AP2.
AP2? 6 up save.
So I got 4 up. 6 damage.
Okay, we're down to, I forget.
12 probably?
16, down to 10.
Oh, 10. Well.
I don't think you can fill morale.
No, they can't. They did not quite lose enough. So we're going to go right on to scoring.
I got 5, didn't get to 1, and didn't score that.
Would you like to get rid of any of these? Just so you can play another one next turn. Because these are the ones you're stuck with. What is it?
Behind enemy lines.
Okay.
If I clear all through, I can get it next turn, but I'm not going to get
it. Gotcha. So we're going to keep 1 on the table. So here are the objectives we're going to go for. No prisoners is kill something. Big game hunters kill something with 10 or more wounds. And 1 mystery objective. Which one is the primary, Steve? Which one am I going to be trying to go for?
I think the hardest thing for you to do is the 10 or more wounds. So that one.
Big game hunter is worth 2 victory points then. Go up to 7 command points. Living metal, he's going to go up to 4 wounds remaining. And that is pretty much it. Other than my will be done and the Lord's will on the Lich Guard right there, of course.
I'll tell you this. I give it to you right now. If your overlord kills Gaz, I concede.
Nice. Sick. We'll get there. Okay. We'll get there. Movement phase, these rays are going to fall back. Oh, living metal as well over here. This guy goes up to 2 wounds remaining. I'm going to fall back to over here. They can fall back, shoot, and charge. I'm just going to make way for the warriors to shoot at him.
Mm-hmm.
The Necron warriors move about 5 inches, getting the front row and rapid fire range of the big battle wagon. Coming over to here, we're going to have the Lich Guard move first. They get to move 6 inches because of Relentless March. And with that, we're going to get these guys moving up here. I want to keep this kind of chain going here for now. They should all be within 2 of another model. You should be there. And then we're going to have, you know what? How do I fix that? I can't really fix that. Because that's where they end up. I don't have room for the Overlord to get through over here. Might be enough room for him to get through over here. Because I want to advance him to get them an extra movement. So we are going to advance the Overlord. He's going to fight, but not right. He's supposed to be at 4 wounds. He's not going to fight right now. He's going to fight later. We're going to advance him. So he's going to go an extra 6. Okay, he goes 12. Impressive. With that, he's going to advance all the way up here.
We're going to get you.
He's going to have 4 wounds left. The Lord behind him will advance as well. An extra 2. Which will get him to about... We'll go there with him. You know what? Before we move them, we're actually kind of defeated the whole purpose. It was to get this guy up and around the corner. So we're going to have the Overlord just end his move there. He doesn't have to actually go in the corner. He didn't need that big of an advance. I don't know why I used it. That will give them a 6-inch move, though, because of Relentless March. I wasn't going to be charging with him, so I figured I'd advance anyways.
That's fair.
So we're going to get him to move there with a 6-inch move, and then the rest are just going to be back up behind him. We'll see what kind of damage they can do to you. They're going to end there, and then that's going to be it for movement. We're going to go into shooting. The only shooting I really have are these Necron warriors over there. There are 4 in the back, 6 in the front. There's 10 of them, so it's going to be 12 plus 4 shots into the battle wagon. I'm going to pop a couple command points here because I need to get as much out of this as I can. We're going to go down to 5 from 7 command points for Relentless Onslaught and Disintegration Capacitors. So what this is every 6 to wound is going to do... Sorry, every 6 to hit. Yes, this makes way more sense. So every 6 to hit is 2 hits, but automatically wounds at the same time. So it'll generate 2 hits. 1 will automatically wound,
right,
and then the other one I have to roll the wound with.
Gotcha.
So that's 2 different stratagems. I am obviously hoping to spike some 6s here. So we'll naturally get a couple. You know what? I'm always happy with kind of... That was not a 6. That was a hit regardless. It wasn't a 6. So we have 2 automatic wounds, but 2 extra hits. So we'll take those into the pool of hits. Then we need 5s to wound. It's only T7, right?
T8.
Oh, jeez, that sucks. Don't show fives. Okay. But it's still something. All that minus one.
Five of the save. Now, it'll be round to eight. I actually have that brackets me.
Ah. Steve's gonna take the two.
Just taking it.
This is a big stretch for me anyways. If I could pull this off, that's great, but I'm not likely to. If they could kill it, because they could fall back, shoot, and charge, then that gets me a lot of victory points and gets rid of this thing off the table too. That's gonna go into charging, which will be them first. I assume you do not want Overwatch.
I do not want Overwatch.
They're gonna charge seven, which will just get me back onto the objective, and I'll go back over here. Keep your two wounds there. And then we got some charges over there. Overwatch from Steve, so we're gonna do the Lich Guard into Ghazghoul, Mag-Uruk Thraka, 9 inches. I'm gonna keep him back there within range of those two guys because I need to provide like a better version of Lukosur for them, as well as Lukosur. These Lich Guard here charge against...
Rook-a-truck Squig Buggy as well?
Just the Squig Buggy, I think.
Just the Squig Buggy.
No, I'm gonna do both, it doesn't really matter. Yeah. Bam. Seven, well if that's a fail, which I don't think it is, I'll reroll it.
No.
And that is gonna end up right there with a seven. Getting stuck on in there now. That's it for charges because they advanced. I don't know who to go with first.
I can't interrupt.
It doesn't matter. Okay, then. I'll go with, since I declared charges with both, I'll go with these Lich Guard first, and I'm not going to spend a command point on the guard ability, which gives Lich Guard plus one attack if they're near a noble, because I think that they should be able to do it on their own. I have six of them attacking. I'm going to keep it like that. I'm not going to bother piling in, and they should have. Three attacks apiece right now. So here are the Lich Guard with their Hyperface Auras attacking Ghazghoul. I know I could wound on threes if I had Disruption Fields here, but I don't think I need to because I have a bunch of War Scythes that could attack him as well. My Rad Wreath does reduce his toughness down to six because he's not a vehicle. So these are hitting on twos because of my Will Be Done, rerolling ones for the Lord's Will. And these should probably do the four damage on their own.
Sure.
So wound with Strength 6. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 wounds. Minus three.
Four up! Oh, you know... It's not gonna make a difference because you're gonna get size on them. So it was four. I failed four.
Okay.
Rerolling one isn't gonna help.
These are only one damage each, anyways.
Well, I know, but yeah. I mean, I think that's four. If I make a save, then you have to put sides into them.
The sides are hitting him no matter what.
I know. Yeah. I was looking at how many sides could get to him. Like some of them can't attack him anywhere to get him. So there's no value to rerolling anything. I'll take my four.
So he's down to eight.
Yeah.
Next with these Lich Guard, they didn't quite touch base, so they're gonna get a little closer to him. Come on in, and then I think you have to go towards Gaz. Your attacks are pointless, though. And then you'll come over there. You get six of the men attacking the Squig Buggy there. I don't think I need to give them a fourth attack for being near a noble. They're nine wounds.
How many attacks do they have?
Three each.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not going to bother. They're only hitting on threes and not rerolling, though, so. Ooh. I'm going to try and conserve my command points here and not give them a fourth attack. It would give me six more attacks in total. I don't think I need it, though. Okay, no, I definitely don't need it. Every single one of those hits. Wow. 7-6 on him, so 3 stun, that's rank 7. No save, but the Deskull save. And these are all 2 damage apiece. We got 5, 10, 12.
Handful of sixes!
He's dead. Does he explode?
No.
No, okay. We cut down the buggy. The goal was to keep Ghazghoul the closest. So
yeah, don't go into him because I was fall back and charge and all that.
Right, so they're both about equal-ish. He can fall. Oh, he's Titanic. That's right. Okay, so definitely not. So you're gonna go there, and you're gonna go over there, just so Gaz cannot fall back. We'll go touch the base. That way he's kind of surrounded by guys. Unless he has a rule. I don't think he can fall back through things, right?
Mm-hmm.
No. Okay. So we'll give.
I actually forgot about my turns.
Your turns?
Yeah. You have more combat phases to kill me.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah.
I'll be fine.
And then these rays will attack. They have 8 attacks. It's a stretch to kill this thing. That's for sure. Forced to hit. Ha! Well, that's a good roll, though. Good start. And then fives to wound. Oh, wow. That's 5 wounding hits. And minus 2. Do I command point this to, like, make it...
How'd you get 5?
I got 5's wild, right? I'll command point one, because I have an abundance right now. This is actually pretty important, so... I don't get it. I'm down to 4. And you got 2 sixes? No, he's dead. Unless you reroll one.
I don't think I need him.
Right. This is more or less me getting 2 points for killing him right now.
But I'm trying to decide whether... Now, if you want to do a bunch of mortal wounds to you next turn, so it's not worth 2 points you can have. Don't explode.
Okay, no explosion. Gotcha. So we do get the battle wagon. That's a pretty cool kill.
Oh, goodness. Good job, goodness.
Bam. And then consolidating. Nah, whatever. Not too concerned about it. We'll keep you to there. Oh, I want to stay within range. No, I know. We'll stay. We'll hang out. Yeah, I know. We'll go the full 3. We'll go right there and kind of block that guy as much as we can. From there, Ghazghoul gets to go. Who's he attacking?
The scythes.
The scythes. Gotcha. Makes sense.
Okay, 2's to hit. And choose a wound.
Yeah, T5.
No.
He's strength 14, I assume, something like that.
So it's minus 4.
Minus 4, that's 4 dead guys. Yeah. Don't really need these two, so they can die. 1, 2. And then 3, 4, I suppose. And then they get to reanimate, maybe. 8 dice, every 5 up. I get back 2 of them. Only, look at that. And we'll reanimate them over here. There. And I guess we can go over here too. Nah, it doesn't really matter. He'll be able to attack him over here too. That'll be it. No morale to talk about. No morale to resolve. Good job, Necrons, I suppose. That was a random, like, really efficient turn 3. Now for my cards, I got Big Game Hunter for 2 because that's one Steve elected, and no prisoners I got for 1 because I killed something. So that's going to be 3 more victory points, putting me at 11 to Steve's 10. So I scrapped that. Steve's at 11. I forgot to mark him for the 1 point he got last turn. So we're in tie game so far.
Oh,
at the
really?
Turn 3. Yeah, we're on turn 4 now. And I'm going to discard this card because it's a secure objective 2. There wasn't really a chance. If I had 1 or 2 more rays, I could have gone for it, but that's the one that is right there. I forgot about Undying Legions, but I reanimated 2 full guys. If I rerolled 1, it wouldn't have mattered. So we're going to go on to battle round 4. Start for the orcs. What? The 10 Grosh should be right...
No, they're going to go over here because I was over here.
Right. That would change how I had to pile. Okay, we'll figure it out.
Sorry, this is going to die real quick.
So three of them.
3
of the 10 Grots are dead, so there's only 7 left in that general area. So
if you go into them, I'm going to fight with them too.
Yes.
Okay.
Not much can be done about that. So the tank was there. I was fighting here. Trying to fix it as much as we can, people, sorry. So I guess we'll...
Do whatever you think is the closest.
Yeah, it'll end up...
That's actually bad for me, the fact he pulled out of the other guy on the wall.
Right. Yeah, it makes the shooting a little bit... Well, I mean, you can still see him pretty well.
3, 6, 7.
You should be able to attack with all of them if you want. Like, that guy just goes like... They're all in range of the objective still.
5s.
Yeah.
Of course. And 6s.
3 up. Okay, we're good. And then morale on them.
They're running. They fail, so there's going to be 6 more.
Yeah, but they're only running on 1s here. No more, just the 1 runs away.
So I'll just...
I know I could have put my rays... Had I remembered they were there, I could put my rays there, but then Steve could have just disembarked up there on the building, which would have been, with the new 9th edition rules, in range of the objective. So it's all good there. It doesn't really change it too much. But that means Steve will score, at the end of my turn, 1 victory point. You're looking back at the objective card. Some of them you can score on your opponent's turn. Some you can only score on your turn. The secure objectives you can only score on your turn. So albeit they're on the objective, but he can't score until this. It should be no problem. He just falls back on anyways. But that means he can only put down 2. The biggest factor is he can only put down 2 objectives for this turn. I'll go show my command protocol now too. It's Conquering Tyrant. It's not going to be that big of a deal which one I choose. Something that can fall back and shoot. I'm just going to do Directive 1. Add 3 inches to the range of My Will Be Done, The Lord's Will, and Right to Reanimation Protocol. I was, just in case things are out of range, I'm not too sure. And the orcs are up to 2 command points as well in the command phase. Now we're gonna go on to movement.
This is simple. We gotta go like this. I gotta make sure I'm gonna go far over and still see those raids. Okay. This guy's coming here.
He's not bad in combat, that's right.
It's this one I don't know if I wanna send in or not. No, I know the answer. He's gonna go this way.
Ooh.
I'm gonna move. Do I fit? Do I fit? And then they're gonna advance these Gretchen. And let's take the max 3.
Right, since the away from.
Oh, sure. You want to pick one that's
Right. We didn't even show off the objective, so we jumped.
Oh
in
yeah.
Folks.
Shall I put in?
So yeah, Steve just got one for nothing but secure objectives on this one. So 1 and 2, which are in his territory and my territory. And he's going to be able to get that this turn. And then, so if you're going to get those, no problem. I'll make that one the one you get 2 points for.
Okay.
2's right there, already on it. And then he can just fall back over here and get it. Which I assume is going to fall back and go for it right now.
Yeah, I was going to do that right now.
Yeah, I am not going to like cut them down or anything. I mean,
this way.
You know what? I have a bunch of command points. I will do cut them
down. Yeah, sure. Why not?
I'm doing cut them down only because if I kill 1 and they fail in morale, like if I kill like double 6, I have 1 dice. Might force a morale check later on. Who knows? Boo. And then maybe Steve
rolls. I could force morale check, yeah.
Yeah, maybe Steve rolls the 5 ones and he doesn't get the objective.
It's true.
Gets me down to 4 command points.
Markinos on fire first in the shooting phase. Everything at those guys.
Gotcha. All right.
Let's do the rockets. No hits.
Okay.
The big gun. 2 4 shots. On 3.
4?
4, 4, 4, 4.
1
I'm
hit.
Gonna re-roll that with
the
skulls.
Yep.
Oh, that's a mortal wound. Oh, I forgot to mark that.
He's got another mortal. He's got two mortal wounds on
another attack for the six. Two hits. Three is to wound. Invuln.
Four ups. Make both.
Belly gun. Hits. I'm going to reroll the wound.
Yep. With the death skulls?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
And, oh, big shooter.
Big shooter.
On fours. Extra shot.
A couple extra shots with the sixes.
And five wound.
I'm T5, so four.
Yeah, it's five. Sorry, four, but they're by fours.
Two of them. Three and a three, I guess? They're okay, they have three up armor.
Oh, okay. This guy's putting everything into them?
Missiles, wing missiles.
Okay, so let's do the 2d3 ones. It's going to be four shots. Let's use these dice. We're hitting on fives. We're going to use the Death Skulls reroll. And we have two more shots for sixes. And then we're going to wound on threes.
Good. Nope, no need to reroll.
Minus two.
Oh boy. Four ups.
Kills one, each one kills one. They're three.
Yeah,
each.
I'll command point one of those. Ah, rip. They're dead. And I'm down to three command points. Hoping to keep him alive a little bit longer.
He's putting everything into them.
Bring it on.
Okay, so I'm within 12 now. So my gun's gonna be plus one to hit. We'll start off with that gun. So it hits on fours.
Sixes are good.
Sixes are good. Four more. Okay. Do I want to use a reroll on on this gun? Yeah, I do. One more. For Death Skulls reroll, didn't help. Threes to wound.
Strength six. Would you reroll one of these?
Do I want to use a reroll on this? It's only minus one, so you know what? Yes. Nope.
Okay. No terrain in the way of this, so just five ups. Oof. So I lose eight so far. I have two guys left. We'll say it's just like those two. Actually, yeah, there's still 10 there. So I got two near the tree left, I guess.
Two twin big shooters? This is only on fives.
That's a good roll.
Two more shots. And threes. Four. No run. No AP.
Four ups. They're dead. You got them. No rerolls. Bye bye, boys. All right, that should be it for shooting because everything else is tied up in combat and the characters are safe.
We're going to go ahead and charge him into the scythes.
Yep, makes sense. Oh, yeah.
He's going to go here. He can't fail, so he's going to go ahead next into the scythes. And then I have to roll dice for his. He's got mortal wounds on the charge. It's a 4+. Nope.
Oh, nice.
And then we're spending two command points for
ramming speed.
Ramming speed.
So no command points left for the orcs.
I'm in.
Yeah.
But,
two up.
Two up.
D3.
Three.
Kills
two.
One. All right, that's important. See if it matters here. We're going to pull this one from the impact hits on the ramming speed there.
Actually, all right, we're going to start off with this guy.
The shock jump dragster?
Yeah. Okay, so I think he's winning. Okay, so he four attacks. He's hitting on fours, death skulls. He's winning on two, threes, because you're death skulls.
I'm T5, yeah. No.
Okay. Then he immediately fights again.
Okay, yeah. I can't interrupt that.
Death skulls.
Does he get to? I guess he rerolls.
You could. You could if you want. But because it's my turn, I choose. These both happen at the same time.
Sure. Okay. Keep going.
And then. Goodness. One. It's only AP two.
AP two. Six up. Or five up, but it still fails.
D three.
Three. That kills the one guy. I'm gonna pull a guy from like back over there near the characters. Five up reanimate. No, he's dead. This guy was only gonna be attacking guys. I am gonna counter offensive with those Lich Guard now to try and do as much damage as they can. And I'm going to spend a command point. Ooh, they might be too far away. Let me look at the range on that, and it depends if I pull this guy or not. That's only 3 inches on Eternal Protectors. It gives them plus one attack if they're within three of a noble. And the current protocol active is only for their abilities there, so I can't increase the range of the stratagem.
Sorry, before you carry on.
Right.
Gaskell's going to shoot.
Yes.
Real quick, into the sides. Sixes.
Five to hit.
Oh, right, because he's now minus one. It's an assault weapon, and three more shots. Didn't help. And threes. It's minus one.
Four ups. We take a damage.
Yeah.
And then.
But then that guy would have died.
Right.
And I did.
I just have a wounded guy right now. Yeah. So nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
Actually, technically nothing happens.
Because I would have killed the wounded guy.
That one guy removed would just have one wound and then he would have finished him off. So I am going to counter offensive with the Lich Guard. They're too far away for Eternal Protectors. But how many wounds does this boss here have?
Ooh, good question.
I don't know how to split these attacks up. It's a hard decision. I'm not going to kill the boss over here. I'd like to go for him if I could. I could put three into the Shock Jump Dragster and then three into the Morkanaut, or four into the Morkanaut and two into the Shock Jump Dragster. And I could spend a command point on Disruption Fields, which I don't think I'm going to do. It's forced. It'd be forced to win the Morkanaut instead of fives because he's T8. He's immune to my Rust Aura or Rad Aura. I'm not going to do disruption fields. I'm going to do 3 and 3 into the Dragsta and Morkanot. I'll start with the Dragsta. 3s to hit him. Okay, not bad. 3 misses is the average. Like to see it. And 3s to wound. Not bad. A couple fails there. So 4 wounding hits at, what's it called?
Mine is good.
Yeah.
6 of it full.
Oh, that's only 6 damage he lives.
Okay.
I assume he's got 8 or 9 wounds.
How much damage is it? 3 each?
2 each.
Oh, okay.
I wish it was 3, yeah.
So that's him?
Yeah. He's got 9 wounds. I couldn't put any more than that into him. I was hoping to spike a little bit higher. And then the Morkanot's a little iffy. I would like to bracket him, but it's not likely. And then I have 9 attacks into him as well. 3s. Oh, nice. Good spike there. The 6s don't matter. And 5s. Okay, we got 3 wounding hits at AP 4. So I don't think he has a save. Oh, Death Skulls? Does it get that?
Yeah.
Yeah, ooh. So Morkanot.
Yeah, Morkanot.
3 on the Morkanot. He takes 6 damage.
Okay.
He's down to 10.
Not bracketed yet.
Sad.
Death Killer Warthrike hits on 2s. We're going to reroll 1 because we're Death Skulls. We got
4.
Yeah, he doesn't know how many. Okay, so 4 hits. It is only strength 7, so 3s.
Reroll for Death Skulls.
Death Skulls, yeah, might as well. This is minus 2.
Oh, he gets reroll wound rolls with that claw. Yeah. So minus 2, I make 1 fail 3.
Okay, these are D3 each.
Okay.
But, 1 second. So the first one
kills the guy.
Second one.
Kills
I'm gonna reroll the death skulls.
Oh, you reroll damage rolls death skulls, eh?
Okay. Yeah, I know it's ridiculous. So 2 dead. How many went through?
Just that many. So okay. He kills 2. And I'm gonna pull 2 from near the characters and see if they reanimate. I get back. Oh, almost. Oh,
wow.
I get 1.5. I can't get the half, but I get 1 back. Actually, gonna reanimate him over there. Probably pull. There we go.
And no more cannot. Sitting on.
Is this his like
3s?
Like spread profile.
Yeah. It's 2 damage one. Rerolling 1 for death skulls. And definitely winning on 2s. Rerolling for death skulls. So I had 9 and minus 2.
Okay. Well, here goes nothing.
Look at them all.
That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think I have 1 left.
3, 4, 5?
No, I have to reroll 1 of them. 5 up.
Whew! That was lucky. I needed them.
I'm so close to pulling out a victory. You don't need this, Steve. You don't need this.
I need.
Now, because it's my turn, I get to choose to fight over here. I am going to... It's probably definitely worth getting his extra attack in. Let me see the order here, because if I pick them to attack, I can give them an extra attack with Eternal Guardians, and then they get to pile in, so I'll get that guy's extra 4 attacks as well. That's whenever I want in the fight phase, apparently. It's not when they're picked or anything. You just at any point in the fight phase, you can do it. So we are going to have you pile in over that way. You're going to get in, and then you're going to move there. And then they're all going to have an extra attack. Never mind, I'm a numbskull. I read that wrong. While they're within 3 inches of the character when they go to fight.
Oh, okay.
So they're going to stay where they are, and they're going to get 24 attacks. But I have 0 command points now. Okay, here we go. Hitting on 2s. Rerolling 1s. I think it was overkill to do these 4 damage, these 4 wounds here, but I kind of needed to make sure I got there. There's the reroll, though, for the Lord's Will. They all hit. And then these are going to be wounding on 4s, because the rad brings his toughness down to 6. So we got 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 wounding hits.
Spike 4s. One, no, I got 4 wounds.
Got him. All right. Got it. I got at least 4. He's down to 4, everyone. He fights back.
I have 6 stacks now. Hitting on 2s. Rerolling 1s. And wounding on 2s. Just 4.
Nice. 4. Shields up. I stop. Well, that kills 2 of them. And that's 4 of them. So reanimate. I get none back. Gaz down to 4. And we're losing a couple of Lich Guard. We'll lose those 2. So no morale to talk
about. I owe you morale, actually.
Yeah, you do owe me 1 over here. They're running.
They're running. 2 run. 2 run.
Wait, only...
On 1. I didn't roll 4 more dice. I only got 2 in my hand.
Oh, okay, yeah.
There you go.
It confused me when you said 2 run. It was 2 in total. It was 2 in total run.
I scored all my cards.
Yes.
So the hidden one was Blood and Guts, and it was Kill Something, so it's...
Oh, Blood and Guts. You got it by just that 1 failed reroll.
Yep. You're getting those for sure.
Yeah, these I'm probably going to be getting. These are the cards. This is the hidden one.
Well, we might as well make that 2. Yeah, those are guaranteed.
Well, it's not guaranteed.
Well, this is guaranteed. Yeah,
that one's guaranteed. That one, I just need to do 4 damage to Gaz. I should be able to pull off. The command phase is Living Metal. He heals back up to full. And we are going to crack the Resurrection Orb on them. Pick a Dynasty unit within 6 inches and roll activate reanimation protocols for all those that are dead. So I'm going to roll. It's not the Orb of Eternity, unfortunately. So I'm going to be rolling 10 dice for Lich Guard. I'd like to get back a couple here. Oh, I will get 2 back. Look at that. 2 Lich Guards stand back up. Well, I am going to resurrect these guys. I think I know what I'm going to do. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to do exactly what I want to do, but we're going to have you resurrect there, I suppose, and then you'll resurrect right there, because why... Actually, no, you're not going to resurrect there. You're going to resurrect over here. Right? Oh, because that blocks that area off there. I need him to get into combat. I want a cool, honorable combat. I want him to go take out Gaz. You know what? It doesn't really matter. I'm going to put him there, and you're going to reanimate over there, because... Whatever, he goes over there. If he dies, he dies. At this point, the score is pretty close. I'm going to hope on I'm going to bank it all on a 4-up and see if that makes a difference.
4-up.
We'll see if he comes back to life with the resurrection, because I get to go last. So if he's... We'll see. Maybe he'll deny a warlord kill. So he's going to give them my whoop done. He's going to do the Lord's Will on them. So plus one to hit and reroll hit rolls of one. He's going to move to about there. And then we're going to advance him. We are going to advance him 5 extra inches. And with that, we're just going to hide behind the building there. That move, we're just going to go ahead and charge in with the Overlord into Gaz. Get him! So we're going to go right there. There's no way the hero can intervene with these things, is there?
I mean, he could.
Who could? He could? Yeah, he's too far away, though. Okay, good. All right, so we're going to charge in there. We fight first with the Overlord. He's going to enact honorable combat, so he gets an extra 2 attacks against Ghazghoul here. These hit on 2s. Reroll 1s for Warrior Nobles. And then these wound on... You're down to T6, so 3s. Rerolling any 1s.
How many?
5.
5?
So you have 6 up saves against this. No invulnerable saves against his weapon.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So it's minus 4?
Minus 4, yeah.
You got him.
Yep, and that is 3 damage each. Down goes Ghazghoul. And then we're just gonna...
I can see.
Oh, that's right. Steve said he concedes if I kill Gaz.
I calculated 3 more turns before I bought my combat phases, so I concede. But we'll just finish it up.
I don't think you lost. It depends on what you're...
No, I just did. I concede.
Sorry?
Oh,
because I killed him.
Because I can't do basic math or forget about the fact that I have my combat phases on my turns too. But it's fine.
I guess. Well, okay. Well, that's the end of my turn, honestly. So scoring, I get Assassinate for a point and Kingslayer for 2 points because I killed the Warlord on turn 1. I actually had that card in the beginning, right from the start.
You were waiting for the proper time?
I was waiting for the, like, when I didn't have cards I could automatically do, and I could mostly do the other ones. This one I don't get. And I'm going to get, it's overwhelming firepower.
Gotcha.
I don't have that.
So you're going to get 3 more points?
I get 3 more points. So I think it's pretty close to a tie, or I'm up by 1.
I'm up by 1.
The last protocol I have is Eternal Guardian. I am going to go ahead and say it's the first directive. Each time an attack is made against this unit, if it did not make a normal move, advance or fall back this battle round, it gets light cover. And Steve gets a command point.
Yep, okay, so...
Oh, what are your objectives, though? What are you trying to accomplish?
Yes. So... which one?
Secure 4, secure 4, and a mystery one. Where's
4? 4's right there, I'm already on it.
Oh, I guess this one then. Yeah. Sad Luka. Don't even need to run.
They're gonna run. I just want to get them back to way over here.
Sure, they move over there.
They're gonna run.
Okay, going for line break. Ooh, I think they make it anyways.
Already did, yeah.
Yeah. See, I could not get... So I was gonna try and do line break with my Lord, and I'm like, oh, he's just gonna walk over there with the Morkanon and block it.
I'll let you know now. That's 4 points.
Is it behind enemy lines?
Yeah.
All right, so that's 4 points for you. Then just go ahead and do whatever else you want to do over here.
Okay, because yes, you could, right?
I could. I'd have to get 5 points on my turn to tie the game.
Okay, so what's going to happen here is...
Stupid Steve.
This guy's going to pull back to about here. A little more, I want to make room for him. This guy's coming...
Actually, like, I'll tell you right now.
Yeah?
Because it's pretty late. I can't actually get 5 points on my turn.
Oh, okay. I was going to try to go for Warlord kill with shooting.
Right. So he can't get shot at. He can't get shot at because he's near the Lich Guard. Okay, even if he's the closest.
He's going to come over here, and then they're going to both fire everybody, and everybody's going to charge back
right in. And then does my Overlord come back to life? Yes.
It does.
Look at that. So you wouldn't get Warlord kill, and you would get Linebreaker, though. So we'll tally up the final score. I'll show you what I was going to get on my turn, and I was going to get it no matter what.
Okay.
It's no matter what. So these are the only two I could possibly do. I guess I'll show you the rest of my hand. It was Supremacy, Secure. I drew this one way too late. I wish, like, unfortunately, I didn't get that early. Endless Legion is, I got this also this turn, which is once I keep a tally of that permanently, once I make 10 reanimation protocol rolls, I get a point.
Oh, so I'm assuming you got it?
No, I have to, like, I got this on the last turn when I wasn't going to be making any reanimation protocol. So that was a bad one to draw later on. I was going to say, those are unfortunate to draw later on. Secure 5, I never...
But you won. Because I can do basic math.
That's true. That's fair. Okay. And then Secure 5 is way over here.
Those grots are still on there.
The grots are on
there. So get this. I was thinking about this. Now, if we were playing a regular 9th edition game, couldn't have won. Because I had to pull back. So because these things are... Okay, Lich Guard. They're crazy expensive for a reason.
They're less than 300 points.
That's crazy expensive for 10-man squad, but they're crazy good. Like, if you stay away from them, you're fine.
Right.
In 9th edition, I wouldn't be able to stay away from them. I would have to stay in those objectives to primary points, or else you would have had me on points, you would have won. So if we, so my thing is, if we play the same list for the same list in 9th edition, you had it.
I don't know. All you had to do is shoot, like...
Buddy, I crumbled hard once they got to me.
You started.
You killed two models before they got to me. And now, like, I'm almost, like, I have three left.
I did have a close combat army too. Like, I had no real shooting, so all my points, they are good. Yeah, Steve's right, they're very good.
But they're expensive.
Yeah, they're very expensive. This is the first time I tried Warscythe Lich Guard. I was kind of hoping to be able to utilize the Monolith to move it forward, spend a command point, pop them out, and then charge and be devastating.
I know, but like, orc shooting is just too reliable. Like, you can't bring a monolith against orcs. Like, you know you're gonna get shot.
Enough. And then, if anyone's curious what these were, is Age of the Machine. If I did kill a vehicle, I think the Warlord, like, I'd probably be, it depends on who's tied up in combat and where. The Overlord might have been able to do it on turn 5. And then Dust and Ashes, I nominate a character. This one is lucky to have at the end. If he's alive at the end of the game, I get a victory point. So I would just choose the Lord over in the corner.
Nice.
And that's just the victory point there. So the final score, assuming, so Steve goes up 4 points, he's at 15, he's at 19, 20 for Linebreaker. I am at 14, 15 for this one, maybe 16. That's all
Man,
I can really accomplish.
Man, I had 20 points, you're 16, and I lost.
That's embarrassing,
That's
right?
That's embarrassing.
Go ahead. Well, I was going to say, it was a little frustrating in the beginning, not because the Monolith died, because it exploded, but that's my own fault for putting so much stuff beside it.
Man, how close of a game did we have, though?
I know.
By the end of it?
It ended up being very, very close.
Okay, so here's the big question. Luke asked you already, do you want to see more of this?
Right. Like, obviously, in this case, Steve built a scoring-based objective deck. It was the...
Yeah.
So the one, technically the boon you had, this game might have been a lot different because you have to use the orc deck.
I don't know.
Because he doesn't have
one.
We don't
have the orc deck.
Exactly. If your warlord is from the orc faction, you have to use their deck. That's why I used the Necron one.
Yeah, I don't even know what they are. I've always used the generic one.
So I guess next time, technically, I just thought about it now, it's in the back of the old orc codex.
I guess that's true, right?
Yeah.
So what were they?
Oh, you have it! You literally have it right there! Oh my gosh! Oh, what a brain fart! What a whiff!
Okay, one of them's random objective. Decrease that objective.
Right.
Make a charge for D3 points.
That's easy. Yeah.
Fight phase. Fight phase.
You still probably would have been fine with that.
Shooting phase.
They don't write terrible.
If you advance your move, I would have scored all of them.
Yeah. Okay.
Well,
it's fine.
Yeah.
It would have been, they
would have been in my deck.
Right.
They would have been, there's advance, charge.
Exactly.
Point, yeah.
Like basic orc stuff. So like that wouldn't have changed anything. For the future, we'll go ahead and use that one. Technically, that's an 8th edition rule.
No, I'll just try to find it. If anybody has the old 8th edition cards, they don't want to sell them to me.
Well, 9th edition will probably hopefully have Maelstrom.
I know, but for here and now, I'm not going to wait. I can't wait anymore. I'll buy them if you have them. They're good for collectors. I have all the old ones anyway. I'll buy them. Steve at MiniWarGaming.com if you want to sell them to me.
8th edition orc tactic cards.
Yeah, just so we can do that. Assuming you guys like this, I think you will, but comment below whether you like it or not.
It's just a nice change from...
we've been playing one mission
for
a long time.
Let's be real, everyone. 9th edition missions are great. They are very well written.
They are.
They're incredibly well written. The secondaries are very fun.
They're not different enough.
But we play about two to three games a week of 40K.
40K, yeah.
Right. So it's the same mission over and over and over again. We miss Maelstrom of War. We miss Open War cards. They're going to come out soon at some point, but they're not out yet. So leave your feedback down below. I would absolutely love to do Maelstrom of War. What we used to do in the mornings, like, do you want to do something narrative? Do you want to do an Eternal War mission? Or do you want to do Maelstrom of War? And then it depends on what we both felt like doing. We would typically do that.
Here's another one. I typically don't like to do this because I get too many emails, but I actually want these. If you're playing a lot of 40K at home and you found that the one mission that we have, 40K, has gotten a little much, and you guys try something at home, we play something different, don't do that, Luke, it's very distracting.
Oh, I was playing Firebrass.
Send me an email about how you play at home that's different, that's fun, it still works, it'll be enjoyable to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. Anyways, folks, we're going to sign off there. It's hot in this room. It's been a long day.
It's hot here.
And we are going to go home. See you guys next week for more Warhammer 40K content. And as always, happy wargaming.
Thanks so much for watching. Now, before you go and watch that post-game show, don't forget there's another battle report in the Mini Wargaming Vault, and that is between Matthew and Josh. Tyranids versus Adeptus Custodes. We're talking Nidzilla here. We got Forge World models on both sides, and we have Josh trying out some new Terminators, Matthew with a couple of Demacarans, Scythe Hero Duel, and all sorts of other monsters, and they're just going to be battling out on a very claustrophobic table using Maelstrom of War mission objectives. So once you finish watching this post-game show, click the link below to go check out that one in the vault. If you're not a vault member, Have no fear. Click the link, get a free 7-day trial. Our Vault members are what allows us to keep us in business, so please consider supporting us today.